Urgent message.
Well, this is Dime Porcupine. I guess you're not up and at him yet. This is me. You may call me to the message. All right? Thanks. Bye.
Skipping. Urgent message.
Trying to get in line to call you. It's been, like, so problematic for some reason tonight. I can't get a dial tone to call you. So this is, like, my fourth location, and the phone went through. I couldn't talk earlier because it was right there. So if you haven't gone to sleep, call me back. Thanks. Bye. Just wanted to say goodnight anyway. All right.
Urgent message.
Hi. I hate that your phone keeps rejecting me. You must have a really bad connection. Anyway, I don't know. It's 11:42. It's not even late. So if you're not asleep, call me back. All right, bye.
Letting me have a couple of days to actually think about what freaking happened the other night. Anyway, it was so funny how I had my whole mind made up on, like, when you leave your ass alone, I just felt like you were trouble. And it's so interesting how vibe is, because I was right, you know. I ain't gonna lie, I do have questions. I'm like, how do you do that? Like, you know, who taught you that? Like, are you a goddamn professional? So on a real note, like, that was amazing. It was totally, like, perfect. Like, if I were to vision what I want my man to be sexually, you would be that person, like, hands down. Am I mad at you? Hell yeah. Because you know that you got those skills. So for you to do that to me, that was not nice at all. Because I was getting to know you in a whole different way. And it was cool too. Like, that other way was also nice, you know. So, yeah, I don't know. You know, it makes me more curious about, like, who you are and what you're really about. I won't lie, you know. But again, I keep feeling that vibe of, like, how you gonna do me like that? That is not nice. So you definitely, at some point, will have to, like, give me that explanation, because I'm just real curious. But that's it. I'm not, you know, in any way mean anything else. I think I'm okay. I'm staying away from you. I'm still going to stick to that one. But I definitely want to know. I'm like, dude, are you on TV? Like,
when I started listening to your show, I realized I don't need to be part of no gang.
Nah.
It's females. All I need to do is know what it is to be a man, and, you know.
Yes. Hey, man, I just want you to know that your show done changed my life, man. Man, I am serious. I was that nice guy, but then I went out on the block, man, and I was like, I just upped my game and was like being more alpha and being more of a stand-up guy and just taking care of myself.
Yeah, now
and man,
but I listened to your show and I was like, what does it mean, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Until I bought your products, understand, listen to all the discs you gave me, and yeah, that's what it is. You know, some people talk about, it's like the 60 on the list.
Man,
you know?
I'm going to tell you like this, man. I just when you called me, I was listening to it now, and you did this sort of natural high from it, you know. I mean, he kind of sparks you up, he kind of gets you going, and, you know, he gets you to, you know, feel good about yourself, like, you know, it's about to be 160.
You take your characteristics that you know about yourself, and you work on those, and you improve those, and you develop a belief system in yourself that nobody can tear down. And that's basically, I can apply it to every aspect of my life, not just with women. You can do it with your employment. You can do it with sports, basically anything you want to, you know, and it gives you a strong belief in yourself.
Dean, if I had your information a few years back, man, I would not have gotten a divorce. I promise you that. And I even say this much, with what I know now, with the mind state I got now, and I've got texts from my ex talking about this is strange, and I didn't put these words in her mouth. She said, you know, Ken, I really respect you. That's what she texted me.
This is Robert Frank, and you're listening to TheManMindset.com, dating help for men, with your host, Steve the Dean Williams.
I'm Tyrone, and you're listening to TheManMindset.com, dating help for men, with your host, Steve Dean Williams. So get on board, long dick style.
This is Debo. Steve the Dean Williams, give me your chain, punk. Yeah, sleep with your lights on. I still got the bicycle. Much love, Steve. Do what you do. God bless.
Yo, cupcakes. This is CT Fletcher, and you're listening to the Man Mindset Dating Show for men with your host, Steve the Dean Williams.
The following program is rated MAN. It contains real game, learning your value as a man, original ways to have her face in the pillow and her ass up in the air. I'm talking her knees pushed so far back, it's touching her shoulders. Touching her without touching her. Having a woman respecting your every move. Buying you gifts. Cooking and cleaning with a smile. And knowing her place at the table. So, for all you human males, cupcakes, surface dwellers, and grass-eating lions, viewer discretion is advised. Meaning, if you don't like the truth, then go find a show that helps you cuddle, complain, and cry about women. Just get the fuck out of here. It is game time!
You've been stressing and second guessing when it come to dating. Ain't no need to worry, this advice we're giving is amazing. Leveling up and the plan is progress. Time to get connected with the man mindset. Helping all my fellas till you got it together. Step it up for the better, that's what I'm trying to tell you. There ain't no limit to what you can be or who you can get. Start pulling high value women because they know you legit. This is the man mindset. Hey, wanna welcome you to the man mindset. Yeah, won't find any other advice like this. On point, never miss. It's the man mindset. Yeah, let's go.
Everybody, what's going on? Class is in session. What's up, everybody? It's your boy, the Dean. Welcome to the show. We got a good show for you guys out there. But before we do the show, gentlemen, want to say all you guys out there, we're 100% original, 100% authentic. Everything we talk about today is coming in-house, and nobody's talking about the stuff that we're talking about. So, guys, please get your crayons out. Soak up the motherfucking game. And first and foremost, let me get all this shit together, man. I got to get my little desk. I got to be doing all this moving around stuff. Anyway, I want to say thank you for all those guys who have liked, subscribed, hit the notification buttons. All my dogs out there, my chat room dogs out there, I want to say thank you very much. I do appreciate each and every one of you. Thank you very much for jumping on this joint. Also, gentlemen, what separates us from everybody else, we bring women to you guys. If y'all want to, y'all know the dating chat line, 509-876-5771. We have our own dating chat line that shows you that can, hey, women are there on right now. I feel like one of these days I have to go back and show y'all, like, go on the chat line like we used to, and I show you how I can pull the women and stuff to show y'all how easy it is. Anyway, guys, we always ask you guys, go ahead and go to Target, Walmart, Hobby Lobby, Amazon, wherever, Michael's, get a 100-piece puzzle set. Gentlemen, put your... go ahead and learn the game by taking driving back home, dumping the puzzle pieces on your table, throw the box away, and start putting the pieces together. One thought, one mind, one way. And that's what's so beautiful about the game that we teach you guys out here. Guys, I want to call in 833-859-8744. Before we get into the show, I do want to say to y'all guys, we're not here to change reality. We're not here to change your belief system or anything like that. trying to show you a different way to see the game. One thought, one mind, one way. Gentlemen, if you have a question, please put a Q if you have a question. If you're talking to any women, please put a T in there. We got you on text message. Or guys, if you call in, if you have a question, we will answer any of your questions that you have. So we want to welcome each and every one of you guys. And today we're going to be talking about how to bring a woman into your romantic orbit and also keep her there, because so many guys don't do that. Okay, so we're going to do that and take your questions and all that other stuff. So let's get into it. I'm the Dean. Class is in session. Before we even start, let me go up and see if there's anybody asking a question. No questions. All right, so we're good. So, gentlemen, go and get your crayons out, and we go ahead and chop up the game. So let's see here. So one of the problems that a lot of you guys have, okay, so it's bringing a woman into your romantic orbit, but also keeping her there. And it's something that you guys don't do very well. And I'm going to break that down to give you guys some clarity and some understanding on how it is you mess it up first and how it doesn't work out for you and why they leave your orbit. And all of this comes into kind of like what the game is all about when it comes into showcasing what you are. Just like a job interview for a lot of you guys, you try to showcase a resume. Okay. And why am I talking about this? Is because when you run into a woman, when you go on a date with a woman, when you're texting a woman, what a lot of you guys out here don't understand what you do wrong. And what you guys do wrong is that you showcase a side of you that you don't even understand. And we're going to talk about that. I'm going to talk about some of the things that you showcase. Because most of you guys think that, most of you guys who don't have game showcase things to women that make them leave your orbit. Now, there, when I say come into your orbit, there are women that come around and they want to get to know you and they seem like they're interested in you. But as I told you before, just like a job interview, y'all do the same thing. You try to stand on a resume of past, right? So let's look at your resume. What is your resume that you have right now that shows your past? And these are things that women can see in you. Now it's a laundry list. I'm going to try to go over all these things because I want to give you all the solution, but we've got to get to the problem because most of you guys don't see the resume you put out to a woman. The resume that most of you guys do, and the problem is that for you, a lot of you guys out here, is that you lose trust and you show the woman why she shouldn't trust you and you reinforce her behaviors, her belief system, her morals, and her judgments by the way you display your dating resume or technically how you market yourself. And based off how you market yourself, what you're telling the woman is that you will always break promises and commitments by the way you move and the way you act. Most of you guys out here will show a woman that you are very dishonest by your resume. Now, again, you can try to pretend that you have game and you can try to pretend that you're that guy, but I'm just trying to tell you, these are the things that you're projecting to the woman without even actually realizing you're actually doing this. Another thing that y'all show women is that a lot of you guys out here are what? Unreliable. Meaning that a lot of you guys are unprepared. And that what I mean by unprepared is that in order to, it's okay, it's not about keeping her in your orbit. It's about her wanting to stay in your orbit without you trying to force her in your orbit, gentlemen. And because a lot of you guys are unreliable, what is showing the woman is that there's no interest. You won't build up interest or anything like that. Also, for a lot of you guys out here, what you say to her is that you show her that you don't know how to communicate effectively. And poor communication, gentlemen, is always going to be a cause of mistrust. It can lead to misunderstandings. It can lead to confusion. And it can lead to frustration, gentlemen, when you don't know or have a mouthpiece in the game. Also, a lot of you guys don't realize your resume shows that there is betrayal. Again, violating, breaking promises and things like that. Your resume shows her that there is a lack of reliability in you. And these things are very crucial in maintaining trust. A lot of you guys have inconsistent behavior, which you're telling her, okay? And how you move and how you think. Because one second you're very contradicted. You contradict yourself. One second you try to pretend to be a man, but when the time comes to be a man, you're contradicting yourself. And that hurts you. Your resume shows that you guys will violate her boundaries. Her boundaries, meaning that I don't want to have sex with you right now. I don't know you. I want to get to know you, but you are showing her that, you know what, fuck you and your boundaries. And what you and with the way you are talking, the way you are communicating, you're also communicating to her that you are the kind of person that's going to put business on Front Street. A lot of these, listen, a lot of these women would love to have relationships with some of you guys on the back end, because some of these women are fucking busy. There are women out there, gentlemen, who don't want relationships. But what they will do is they will find somebody to fill in those gaps when they're really busy. Just that one guy to fill in that gap. But she can't trust you when your resume is saying to her that I'm going to put your business on Front Street. A lot of you guys, your resume shows a lack of accountability. Most of you guys refuse to take responsibility for how you move, how you think, and all the things. It just kills the trust, gentlemen. Okay. Another part of your resume shows that there is a breach of confidentiality, meaning that if she shares information with you, you're going to betray that, her privacy. A lot of you guys is manipulation. Is all about also resume is about manipulation. Excuse me, it's about manipulation, meaning that your resume is full of manipulative tactics, lies, ways to manipulate, because most of you guys don't know how to move as men. You remember the truck driver we had earlier today, the truck driver that called in. He's talking about, you know, I just want a woman to come over my place and fuck, right? It's crazy. But yet on his profile, he's looking for a relationship, which another thing your resume shows is that you're very inconsistent, not just with your communication, you're contradictory. So you're always sending the woman mixed messages and you're sending her conflicting information and you guys are failing to communicate clearly. Then that creates confusion and that creates mistrust. Most of you guys don't realize when you're talking to a woman, you push and create a lack of transparency. A lot of you guys withhold information. What's the most important information? All you're trying to do is fuck, but you want to cloak that in. I'm interested in you. I want to get to know you better. You hide your intentions. You move in a secretive manner, and what that does is that makes a woman not want to be in there, okay? Do you see what I'm saying? That's the problem with a lot of you guys, because most of you guys out here as well, your resume says that I'm going to break promises. Failing to keep the things that you say you're going to do in the beginning, you don't do those. Also, unfair treatment. A lot of you guys who come from the manospheres and the red pill spaces and stuff, when I'm talking about unfair treatment, it's verbally abusing. It could lead to physical abuse and any type of thing, because there's a lot of anger in a lot of guys out there. And also a lack of integrity for a lot of you guys. It could be a lack of integrity. Okay. No principles, no values, no program. So when you look at all the things that I'm saying to you guys right now, this is what you're projecting to the woman. You think that you can hide these things, but you project these things and you show these women that, you know what, I'm just not the guy because of all these layers of things that's going on and hurting your chances. Now, as I said before, see, when you have game, so like I always tell you with the interview, game is in everything. So a person that has game, and guys, I got a question, put a Q in there, and I just want to say thank you very much. Appreciate that. Appreciate that. Thank you very much. So let me explain the job as game, but break everything down to you. So when I would go out, when I would try to get a job or compete, the competition is in the room. And here's your first problem. You're so busy looking at the room, you're so busy making judgments of other men, that you automatically push yourself way out because you're too worried about the next man versus feeling like you are the man. When I go in, whether it's a job or talking to a woman, I feel I am the man. I might not get her or I might not get that job, but I don't give a fuck. But I always go in that way, gentlemen. And what I'm saying to you guys is that then what you do is you try to impress the person that's interviewing you like you would do a woman. You want to impress her. You want to come on a front of, well, I'm going to act or pretend to be impressive just like you would when you're on a date. Most of you guys, when you think about a date, most of you guys set up a date. Let's say you have a date tomorrow. Okay, most of you guys are going to wake up buzzing with energy, just excited about it, right? But then there's a part of you that feels nervous because, or a little bit anxious, because what? Of the uncertainties that lie ahead. So that means that, okay, you've got to the point we all talked and the date is about to happen, or the day of the date, okay? The day of the date. So on the day of the date, you have a bunch of uncertainties, okay? And you know that you've got to put on or display a certain part of you, okay? And you've got to pretend and play a role to try. Now, again, for most of you guys, you're trying to play a role to manipulate her to open her legs for you. So you go to the date. You open at that door. And then all of a sudden, gentlemen, a reality sets in. You can feel when you see her, if it's at dinner, which y'all shouldn't be doing, but whatever the date is, for a lot of you guys, you feel your heart jumping out of your chest. Mentally, you start to sweat bullets. And the nervousness that you had earlier today, that day, excuse me, turns into terror. You begin to feel uncomfortable. You start to look around the room and try to figure out, what should I say? What should I do? How should I move? You see what I'm saying, gentlemen? You sit around and you imagine, oh my God, what do I do in this moment? How do I say? What do I say? Why do I say? How do I keep her interested? And all you do in that moment is you are trying to find an answer to all these questions, and yet you begin to feel intimidated by the woman. So you sit down right in front of her or across from her. And your heart moves from your chest into your throat. Your hands begin to shake. You start to sweat. Then suddenly, unexpectedly, the woman just starts to strike up a question or ask you, tell me about yourself. A simple question, a simple statement. But you're too nervous to say a word because what a lot of you have done is that you portrayed a role that you're not. And you tried to be somebody you wasn't. And then all of a sudden, she is going to recognize by the way you're moving when you start to stutter. Okay. You're blinking, you're looking away, you're not looking at her and everything like that. You're not doing that. And this scenario always kills a lot of you guys, no matter if it's a dinner date, if you're at Lake Spread, your ass cheeks, if you're hanging out with a woman, all these things, it doesn't matter. All these things doesn't matter. Because the problem is there is a lot of nervous energy going on with you, and most people don't understand that. But we have to understand why it is you guys get nervous. Why do you feel a little nervous? And all this is important to understand why she will never stay in your orbit. Why is your chest thumping? Why your palm sweaty, mom spaghetti, right? Why your hand shaking and things like that? And the reason why you get nervous is because your nervousness, you being nervous happens when you're unsure about yourself when facing intimidating circumstances. So the moment you look at a woman and say she's beautiful, you have already just set yourself up for a downfall. The moment you say, I got to smash, I want to get that pussy, look at her titties, look at her ass, man, I want to get that. You have just set yourself up for a downfall. Because now you have created what is an intimidating circumstance. Now, listen, a woman can step in your orbit or put a finger in there, dip her toes in your orbit, but she's not going to stay in your orbit. Because all these things that you begin to think about what it is you want to do, I want to fuck, I want to smash, right? And this is where you guys mess up and we go right. Because everything's going to go wrong because there's no program in how am I going to get that woman to open her legs? And that's y'all's problem. But what you think, how you move, how you behave, but most importantly, gentlemen, what it is you fear, your nerves come up and happen when you begin to look at what happens. It happens to all you guys. And it doesn't, listen, gentlemen, what I'm saying to you guys is not a bad thing, but it's time to start understanding the why it happens. Because even though you're in front of somebody you never met before, you're not actually in that present moment because all of a sudden you start to indulge in bringing up past memories of mistakes and failures, and you bring those things into the present moment. And see, what you don't understand when you're not rooted in the game and you're not rooted in yourself, gentlemen, your nerves, your nervousness, inconsistent, all the things that I said in the resume that you display to a woman is nothing more than interpretations you make about your life. That you make about your life. But what if I told you those things aren't actually even fucking real? Rather than lies that you have created to hold yourself back. But these things that you have, these nerves, because you feel, you're thinking in your mind, I have to impress her. Do you really? Well, wait a second. The asshole doesn't look out to impress her. We don't give a fuck. But why do you care? Oh, I've got to get her to fill in the blank. But the motherfuckers who get to women, we don't give a fuck. There are no nerves. And that's what makes her nervous, because why is he so cool, calm, and collected? But they can read and they can recognize, okay? They can read and they can recognize, okay? But what I'm saying to you guys is there, when you're feeling nervous, it's time to what? And now watch this, gentlemen. Instead of running away from the nerves, which you've always been doing, why don't you try something different and take advantage of the nerves that you're feeling? I know that sounds crazy because, again, remember, we always tell you, no one tells you about this. See, the thing is, because you're nervous about being nervous, is that what happens is you bring out uncontrollable trembling, shaking, and anxiety. Because all that does is it blinds you and blurs out a lack of clarity of thought, gentlemen, that you should have in your mind. So then because you are nervously worrying about the nerves, it's a hard time concentrating. And as a man, we, again, when I go into the interview, I'm saying the interview as well as the date, let's say the interview. So most of you guys, when you go into the interview, Petey, hold on, wait a second, Petey, I'll answer your question in 1 second. What happens to most of the guys out here? Okay, so when I go into a, when I go into a interview, I don't look at the people. I don't dress. I don't have the nice suits and all that other stuff. Now I smell good. I have my, you know, clothes and stuff, but I don't go in there trying to display my clothing like I'm in a fashion thing. I wear the best clothes I can, but I don't stand on my clothes, and I don't even look at who I've got to talk to. I'm not thinking about them. I'm already moved past them to where they say, oh, Mr. Williams, can you hold on 1 second? I want to go get my manager. Oh, my God, you got to meet this person. That's how it always works. Why? Because I'm not setting up an interview. I'm talking to the person like we already know each other. Because I'm going to scan that whole motherfucking room, and I'm going to find a talking point to talk about and discuss with that person interviewing me to show her why me, or the him, why me. But when I'm talking to a woman, I don't have to scan. Gentlemen, remember, I don't need to scan the room to be able to talk about anything. I can just scan my motherfucking self. I can scan me. Because I'm not restless. I'm not agitated. But see, gentlemen, when you lead yourself with poor decision-making, you lead with hesitation. It stops you from taking action, and it creates disadvantages of nervousness. And that's why most of you guys are not actually growing as men. What you're doing is you're showing the woman that I'm just not the man for you. Let me ask this question real quick. So what is the reason males get jealous when their girl has guy friends? Well, first off, P-Dog, okay, I know you're new here, so let me help you out. Okay, in this place here, we have freedom, and we are free from talking about other men because we don't give a fuck about the next man here. We don't care about the next man. Fuck him. Now, if you're talking about yourself, I'll take it that you're talking about yourself. The reason why you get jealous when a girl has guy friends is the same reason why I'm talking about what I'm talking about right now. Because if you look at your cupboard and how you move, P, the problem is you just ain't gamed up. And the problem is that you know that because your bedroom skills are so bad, that you know if she walks, you're asking yourself every day, is this the day I'm going to lose her? But see, when you have game, motherfucker P, we're not the one saying, is this the day that we lose her? She'll wake up saying, is this the day he's going to get rid of me? But see, because you don't have any game, P, the thing is that you're worried about the next man, thinking about the next man, judging yourself to the next man versus yourself. So your decision making goes into your hesitation and all these things. So this is why you have the problems that you have, because most of you guys out here don't have game and you don't stand on anything. You don't do that at all. Not at all. Don't stand on it, and it doesn't work for you guys. So what happens, even in this question, or you guys on a date, or you guys texting a woman, when you are feeling nervous, okay, what you don't understand is that nervousness helps you when you learn game, because a man is always looking to expand not only his awareness, but also his understanding of a situation. Every woman that you deal with is not going to be the same. So the only thing that has to be the same in the game is you, because you're the common denominator. But for you, if you feel uncomfortable, you're going to make her feel uncomfortable. You see what I'm saying, guys? And you're not looking at yourself to learn new and interesting things that give you experience. You guys don't even sit and try to figure out ways to make a woman smile, to make her laugh, to make her blush, to make her feel sexy, to show you that you're an interesting person. Y'all don't even think about that stuff because your mind keeps you within your comfort zone, okay? And what I'm saying is that you're not stepping out and you're not learning who you are. See, what I'm trying to get you guys to do is I'm trying to get you to learn you. And why do I say that? What I'm saying, as a student of the game, I had to learn, okay? I had to remember that what? No matter what happens, because I didn't understand until I had understanding of understanding that I'm always in control. But for a lot of you guys, control is an illusion. And the problem is that you have to drop the illusion of control and focus on the things you can control. And the only thing that you can control is you. The only thing that you control is you. Most of you guys feel that you can't do it on your own, meaning that that's why you go to the manospheres and the pills and all those other places, because you feel that I need to be a part of something. But that's right. That's 1,000% right, but 1,000,000,000% wrong. No, it is true. The fact that, you know what? See, your I can't do this on my own puts you into an I do. So you look to another man to guide you on hating women and making excuses and labeling and judging and all that other stuff. What is hurting all you guys out here? But when you are a student of the motherfucking game, okay, when you're one of one, and you are a student, you know you can't do it alone. And because you can't do it alone, what you will do is you will find all the answers of your cult and your community inside of yourself. See, the one that has game doesn't look to the outside world for the answers, because he has the answers because he has created everything. So no, you cannot do it on your own or by yourself, but you can do it because you are one thought, one mind, one way. How you move, how you think, how you operate, you always look to yourself. You never look to anything else outside of yourself. But the moment you start to look outside of yourself to try to find somebody else, then that's when you become two of one, four of one, five of many, and things like that. So you actually do more harm to yourself than good, gentlemen. Also, I realized that you guys feel like you don't have time. Everything has got to be rushed and all this other stuff. Let me bring in area code 818. 818, sir, how can I help you, brother? What's up? 818, what's going on, man?
Hey, what's up, man? How's it going, man?
You got it, brother. How can I help you, man?
Yo, I need some insight, man. I never ran into this situation, but I'm trying to figure this out. When a woman's trying to ask you for some dick pics, like, what's your experience on that? How should you move on that?
Okay, well, never send a woman a dick pic online.
Okay.
So if she's okay, here's my question. When she asked you for the dick pics, what did you say?
I kind of just ignored it. I just went and told her, like...
Wait, stop. Hold on real quick. You're running away. Okay, remember, as a man, you got to head things head on, but you also got to lead things.
Yeah. Here's the reason why I was a little bit hesitant, because it's just like, I feel like... If I would have sent it, then I'm just like being like everybody else.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? Putting myself out there on the market. Like kind of like the same.
Yes.
Like you telling them not to put the dick on the market.
Yes. And yes.
I don't know if it was like a shit test. I don't know. You know what I'm saying?
No. I got the answer. Of course I'm
going to give it to me.
Of course I'm going to give you a dick pic. I'm free tomorrow night at 8 o'clock. I want you to bring your ass to my place. And not why would I give you something in 2D when you can have that shit in 4D? Not only can you see that shit straight off, but you can taste it, touch it, and feel it. So if you want that dick pic bad enough, now see what I took what she's saying, but now I'm leading the situation. Don't ever get intimidated by an aggressive woman. You've got to take that aggression and you've got to move it to your benefit. So I'm not
Yes. Back to you were saying, like, I wasn't running away from it. I responded.
I'm not saying you run. No. What I'm saying is you didn't know what to say or do. Remember, you said you didn't know what to do. So the
Here's the thing, it's like I always had to stand up for myself. It's like, yo, I'm not, you know what I'm saying? I'm not going to put myself out there like everybody else.
Sir, listen, it's not about putting yourself out there. It's not about, it's you leading the question or leading what she's saying. She's saying, send me a dick pic. I'm saying, fuck your feelings and fuck what you think. Why would I send you a 2D photo when you can see this dick in 4D? You bring your ass over here and you can see this. You can see the dick. You can touch it. You can taste it. Hell, I even smack it up on your cheek if you want to. And you can feel it. So why would I give you something minimal when you can have this dick in 4D?
That's what's up.
Right. So.
It's this woman I met last night. She's from out of town. You know what I'm saying?
Now watch this. Now wait, if she's out of town, how do you want to move on this? Watch this. Instead of me sending you a dick pic, give me a reason to even have a thought of sending you a dick pic. What are you going to do for me to even give me a thought of even doing something? You know you're not going to do anyway, but just because you asked for a dick pic, I ain't going to give you that shit, bitch. Why would I do that?
For sure.
Right, you see what I'm saying?
I already knew, like, from the jump, this is, like, not to automatically think and just go ahead and do that shit, so it's just...
Don't do that sucker shit. No. Never, right, never.
I was just trying to make sure, you know what I'm saying? I was going about it the right way. You feel me?
Yeah. You got to make sure that you lead the conversation and handle shit. So let me give you an example. So you met her yesterday?
Yeah, I met her yesterday.
Okay, tell me about the interaction of you meeting her. What happened when you met her? Walk me through that.
So here's the thing. Here's the thing. So you told me from the jump, you tell us from the jump, like, as soon as you see a female, like, motherfuckers, just go for what you want, right?
Mm-hmm.
So we in line, we at this day party and shit, and then I straight up just tell her, like, yo, you know, you caught my eye, and I find you very compelling, and I'm not going to let your ass pass me up. So we exchanged information, and then we went from there.
But what is going from there? What was the next move? What made her ask for a dick pic? What did you say to her that made her ask for a dick pic? What was, go read the message you said. I'm missing something. It seemed like she's just not going to ask for that. What did you say before to make her ask for that dick pic?
So it was in the text, like, later on last night, you know, like around 2 a.m. or whatnot. She's with the girls and everything. And then I called her up. And then we just having a conversation. Like,
a conversation about what?
I'm trying to see you tonight, you know what I'm saying? And then she was like, yeah, I want to see you. You know, I fuck with you. I like everything about you. You were very direct with me.
So why didn't she go see you? Wait. Then why didn't she come see you?
I don't know. I mean, like I said, she was asking for pictures.
So you're missing the point. Are we about talking about it or being about it?
We about it.
So is she talking about it or is she being about it?
She's talking about
it. So if she's talking about it, not being about it, what's the program say to a motherfucker wasting your time?
Dismiss her ass.
Then why wasn't she dismissed then? See, what happened was... See, she threw you off. Say, okay, you talking about come see me, right? Right?
Yeah.
But you wasn't specific in... where, why, and how, and da 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 da. You just talking shit. So if you talking shit, she's just gonna talk shit back to you. You talking about you talking about come to the crib and all this spot, but she threw you off your mark by asking for a dick pic. She threw you off. What and wait, okay. What you should have done is taking the statements that she listen, you got to hold these women accountable for the fucking statements that they make. And if she's saying to you that I want to see you, then hold her to her fucking statement. If she is not doing that, then you dismiss her motherfucking ass.
I copy that.
Right. And well, you know it's going to make her come see your ass because you chin. See, okay, let me tell you something about women. They're so used to talking shit to you motherfuckers. And if they're smart enough to give you crumbs of interest and they know you're satisfied with the crumb, fuck the crumb, I want the cake. Fuck the cake, I want the bakery. Fuck the cake, fuck the bakery, I want the building. I want the street. I want all that shit. But I don't want to waste my fucking time. And that's what you did. You wasted your time. So now she's out of town?
Nah, she's still here.
So then why don't we go ahead and call her? Why don't we call her right now and tell her to bring her ass over to your place?
So I already called her earlier. She didn't pick up. And I left her a voice.
What did you leave on the voice message?
I left her what was really on my mind. I told her straight up, like, you know, I want to eat that pussy. I want to, you know, taste you and everything. And it's, what's up? Like, if you're free later on tonight, I'm free.
Brother, stop. Now you're pushing. You're going too deep.
Okay. So that was a big fuck up right there.
A huge fuck up because, what did she say? I want to see you, right? Right?
Yeah.
But yeah, you, okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Why don't you see her first and see where y'all at and then do all the things? Okay, remember, you're doing the same thing she's doing. You're popping your fucking gums. You talking about it, but you ain't being about it. Baby, I want you to come over here. I want to eat that pussy right now. I want to lick that pussy and need to eat your ass or whatever the fuck you said to her, right? Right?
Yeah.
So what are you telling her? You're not experienced, man.
Yeah.
If the experienced motherfucker is going to say, just come on over, leave it to the imagination, let things roll. But you sitting over here putting extra pressure on yourself, talking about the shit you want to do. Now the pressure's back on you.
Yeah.
Does that make any sense?
That makes a lot of sense, huh?
Yeah. So I'm just saying, nephew, you just got to make sure that when they say something like that, you hold them accountable. If they're not about that, you dismiss their asses. But if you talk to them, don't talk about what you're going to do. Get their asses over. So technically, you move from A to C. The B was to come over to do the C. So remember, okay. So what did the resume tell her? What did your resume tell her? That I am not experienced with women. Because an experienced motherfucker ain't going to talk about, I'm going to come over and eat that pussy. No, I'm going to get you over first. I'll fuck all the C's. Fuck all the stuff I want to do. We got to get you over to the motherfucking house. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Okay.
I got it. I just needed some insight.
And hold on a second. Everything. Hold on a second. Motherfucker, he taking, why the fuck you ain't taking notes? Shut up. Don't ask why he taking notes, motherfucker. Don't worry about why he taking notes. Why the fuck you ain't taking notes, motherfucker? I'm sorry, I didn't check a motherfucking thing. Don't worry, guy. No. Take your notes. Don't explain yourself to another motherfucker. Now I had to talk to my chat room dogs. Don't let no motherfucker ask you shit. Because it's the motherfucker that ain't taking notes is the motherfucker that's losing. So shut your ass up and lose, man. Stop doing that shit. Stop asking other men questions. Why aren't you taking notes? Anyway, Carl, I'm back. Yeah, so you're good, my brother?
No, I'm good. I needed some insight.
No, it's all good. You know. No, I'm proud of you. I think that was good. It's just, listen, don't fall into the dick pic thing. And listen.
That was my biggest thing because I already, like, I've never ever done that. And I know it's like, that's you putting yourself in a category. So I'm like, I already knew.
Don't let her draw the dick out by sending you nude photos. Don't reply to the news. Just act like, okay, I've seen these before. I get these all the time. So that ain't special to me. What's special to me is you getting your ass over to my crib. That's what's special to me. You know what I mean?
Facts.
Okay?
But yeah, this is gonna be a learn from me, going forward.
It's all good. I'm proud of you. No, it's all love, man. Good job. Okay, you have another question? Let me know. Okay, brother.
I appreciate it. Thanks for taking my call.
Good job. Respect. Okay, lines open, gentlemen. Y'all call in or ask a question. But let me continue, guys. So what I'm saying to y'all guys out there, a man, the way a man thinks, okay? A man never thinks about if I ignore it, it will go away. And that's for a lot of you guys will do. You always ignore the problems. You always ignore the lack of growth. You always ignore the poor resume, as I said before. A lot of you guys ignore that you have that you don't know any game. You ignore that you're not transparent. You ignore that you don't know how to take accountability. You ignore that you don't know. You're always trying to push boundaries. And then you're always wondering why things don't walk out for you. Okay. All right. Okay. My brother, let me tell you something. Listen, brother. Listen. Please listen. Listen. Worry about your fucking self. This is why you ain't fucking. And this is why you ain't getting any pussy. Because you ain't taking any kind of notes, man. Because you're thinking about what another man's doing. So please stop that, dog. Come on, please stop that, dude. And I don't mean to put you out there, dog. You got to stop that bullshit. But see, the man that is trying to learn game, and a man that is actually a student of the game, what he is going to do is he's going to connect with the woman on a deeper level. See, what you guys don't understand is that, remember, we're the only one showing you this. Always remember, most of you guys are attacking the surface. She is being run by her second level. Remember, there's conscious and then there's a subconscious. But we are attacking the emotion because the emotion influences her reality, and it shapes how she makes her choices and decisions, guys. And that's why the power of the game is so important, because the influence is not trying to influence her. Is that when she's influenced by why we're so different, why we move so different, why we think so differently than most guys out there, that's the thing that influences her. Because the thing is about most of you guys out there, y'all are not influencing women because you're not influencing yourselves. And if you're not influencing yourselves, okay, what I'm saying, this is why y'all mess up. This is why things go wrong for you guys. Because most of you guys out here are not looking at how to make a unique mark in the world. On everything you do, you should make a mark or leave some kind of impression on the woman to make her not leave your universe, but want to stay in it. Okay, you want her to want to stay in it, gentlemen. And you can't have her stay in it if you are always sitting around nervous. Okay. If you guys out here are always, you're so familiar with how you feel around women that most of you guys don't actually go for or try to overcome. I don't want you to overcome the nervousness. Allow the nervousness to take its course, to come in and go the fuck out. It's going to be there, because as long as you don't believe in yourself, gentlemen, okay, you're always going to have the fear of this. And this is the greatest fuck up. Your fear is, I don't want to embarrass myself. I don't want to get rejected by her. I don't want her to criticize me, and I don't want to make a mistake. You know what a man says? I don't give a good goddamn what the fuck she think. Fuck what she think. And I'm not being mean here. I don't go, what? Why the fuck, if I'm the motherfucking man, why would I give a fuck if I embarrass myself? If she rejects me, it's not my loss. She can criticize me. I don't give a fuck, and I don't make motherfucking mistakes. So how can I be nervous? Because I better, remember I told you guys, I'm trying to teach you how I have what I have, a gambling addiction, to gamble on yourselves. Most of you guys don't even question the fears that you have. You just accept it as is and don't even question what's going on in you guys. You guys never ask yourself, whenever the fear pops up, oh, you can't get her. Oh, you're too short. You don't have enough money. Oh, she's going to turn you down. You motherfuckers should be looking at fucking fear and laughing at that bitch in your mind and saying, wait a second. What is the worst that can happen? What? She ignores me? She says no? She has a boyfriend? Is that the worst? Or for you guys, you think that the worst that can happen is the sky is going to crumble, meteors going to come and blow up the world and all this? Y'all guys take this shit way too far. 504, what's up, brother? How can I help you? What's up?
Hey, what's good, Steve?
How you doing, sir? What's up?
I'm good. So if I'm like interacting with a woman and
stop. You know how we do this. Stop. How are you interacting with a woman?
Well, I just be myself, I guess.
No. Well, see, then that's why yourself sucks, because you cannot communicate yourself. I'm asking you. See, here's the thing I'm going to show you that most people don't do. I'm not going to take what you're saying for face value. You've got to give me more. You say you're interacting with a woman. What is interacting like? What does that mean?
Well, it's just setting up something and you're going along those lines. And
well, what lines? Okay, so you're interacting with a woman in what way?
What do you mean? What way?
Well, you just said I'm interacting with a woman. So what's the play? What's the play? You're interacting for what? And how are you interacting? No, I got you. No, listen, I'm not trying to intimidate you by this.
Yeah.
But this is the difference of men versus you surface dwellers. Y'all just remember, you waste your time. You waste your words, you waste your actions, because you just do that shit. Men don't do that shit. So I understand. You say, okay, let me keep going. But when you're saying, when you're interacting with a woman, what? What's the rest of your question?
Well, the question was, let's get that out the window. I'm just asking a question. So, well, if the subconscious and her conscious, are those like controlled, like, does that control her being, or is it the emotion?
The subconscious controls the conscious.
I was thinking about that.
Wait a second.
Yeah.
But her conscious controls you.
Mm-hmm.
Because she will display from the conscious, the surface, she will display
a
lie, makeup, eyeliner, push-up bras, tight clothes. So what she displays on the surface already has you intimidated. But remember, the resume that she's looking at, the program, her program can recognize the things I was saying, that you are unreliable.
Program.
Yes,
she's got a program,
right? Yes, okay. The subconscious is actually moving her, but what is moving the subconscious is the emotion. The emotion controls the two because of her low self-esteem, insecurities, and low self-worth, right?
Mm-hmm.
They have these things. So they cover them up by, on the surface, makeup, eyeliner, weave, blush, mascara, plastic surgery, and all other stuff. So they're being run by something deeper. But I'm saying, if you attack that deep thing, then you're going to shift her reality, because that's the core of everything. The emotion, not the remember, the subconscious is how she's taking in information. So that's how she's kind of like separating everything and everybody based off of your resume that you're putting out to her. So she's not looking at you from the surface. There's already a program in place that already is looked at you, looked past tense. There's already a resume already set up for the guys that she is not going to be interested in. She might come into your solar system, but she'll go right the fuck out. And guess what? You ready, caller? Mm-hmm. Then she has a way to get you to go into her solar system and play by her rules then. So she can come in, she can come in, run shit, and then have you come back to her side.
Okay. All right. So as a man, I just peep that and like, I just, you know, not waste my time in it.
Peep right? Nothing. Peep. Okay. The moment you peep it, why are you peeping it? Then you've just given 20 points away. She's rent free in your head now because you're peeping it. You're thinking about her versus just being. Remember, as a man, I just am. I am. I'm not trying to do anything special. I am special, but I'm not trying to do anything special. Everything I do is in-house. I've created it. So I'm not doing it to be special or different and all other stuff. I am. Because I'm one of one. Does that make any sense?
Back to the subconscious.
Yes.
The conscious and
yes.
Emotions. Is the emotions lead to her? All right. So what if I like bring out an emotion, right?
Watch this. Okay. If we look at I'm going to show you while I'm talking to you, I'm going to show everybody the blueprint. But what I'm saying, this is very important to understand. This is why most of y'all fail. So always remember to grab the blueprint. Always remember this. Okay. So if you are either in the I do or the I can't, you can never have access to her emotions.
Mm-hmm.
The pathway to getting into her emotions comes from the I am. Because the access they give us is how they feel about us. Remember, keyword feel. You know, I miss you. Yeah. I think about you. You're on my mind. Most guys don't hear that. So you can't, watch this. You can't access her emotions when you're emotional.
Because I'm in the hand, can't, right?
No, when you're emotional. Well, yeah, when you're emotional. Nervousness, fear. Because what you're doing is you're playing on her level. You see what I'm saying? Her greatest strength is her weakness because you make her weakness her strength by uplifting her, putting her on a pedestal, and rolling fruit at her feet. Oh, she's so beautiful. Tap dance. Oh, she's so this. And oh, I've got to feed her, and I've got to kiss her ass, and I've got to beg and barter and all this other stuff. But we're saying fuck that. Why the fuck would I beg you? This ain't about you. This shit's about me. But guess what that makes me? An asshole. Who the fuck do you think you are? You're so selfish. You're an asshole. You're a jerk. Da 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 da. Selfish. That's my access in.
Yeah. Okay. All right.
But no, I'm listening to you. Yeah, but does that make sense though?
Kind of. I'm still, I have to let it marinate to me a little bit.
Well, okay, I'm gonna help you out. Think about this. So, your nervousness, right, connects to low self-worth, insecurities, and self-esteem issues.
Mm-hmm.
You are then playing on her level field because then at that point, she is the master. She's the master of feelings, emotions, and all that other stuff. You are playing on her level of feelings,
because they're naturally emotional, so they
right. So that's doing. Why they yeah. have that. That so that gives them exactly. the power, right? Yeah. Right. Yeah, so then yeah. it goes back to the three pigs, right? Remember that the fable of the three pigs, right?
Mm-hmm.
Well, she's the big bad wolf, right?
Yeah.
They see a beautiful woman and they're intimidated because then they build weak structures that she what. She huffs and puffs and blow those motherfucking structures down. But then, hold on, let me show you the pigs. But then if you look at the third pig, right? Then yes. It's the individual that then imprisons himself. He doesn't, the bricks are not to protect. It's a mental imprisonment saying that I'm going to follow her motherfucking lead. I'm going to do what she wants to do, right? But what, mm-hmm. but what Unc is saying, what I'm saying is that fuck those three pigs. Be the one thing her mind has never met. Like, okay, remember, nobody knows about the fourth pig, right? Remember, we've only grown up to do what? Yeah. We've only grown up to know three, right? But see, when you have game, you learn that there was a fourth motherfucker, and that fourth motherfucker made goddamn statements. He said that fourth motherfucker said, "Hold up, I am." So you're going to know what the fuck I am, keyword I am, when you start fucking with me. Because I'm not going to hide. What you see is what you get. So before you make that motherfucking move, just know that I'm not like them other three motherfuckers. I am a one of one. I'm different. Right?
Yeah, he's going to fuck back. Like, he's going to...
Right, I got your question. Hold on one second. I got your question. But that also, what that also does is that's what intrigues the mind. Remember, the mind is always looking for answers to new things to give it definition. Her mind is always trying to. She cannot. Okay, if all her life. She's already figured out average guys. Then the mind has cobwebs, right?
Yeah.
Right? So then if she meets a man, the cobwebs start to turn a little bit because they're like, oh shit, who the fuck is this? Why is he moving this way?
Mm-hmm.
Because what a man does is he makes a lasting impression on her. Because he's authentic. Okay. He's the authenticity is not to her. The authenticity is being true to your fucking self and being genuine in who you are and saying, this is who the fuck I am. Accept me or don't accept me. I don't give a fuck, but you know what? Because we don't give a fuck, that throws off the program. Because the program is run off of the emotion of you giving a fuck.
Right. Yeah.
So that's the thing that hurts a lot of young men because y'all give a fuck. We don't care. Yeah, listen, I'm not gonna dress. Listen, okay, yes, sir. Well, in Vegas, I gotta wear I gotta dress up a little bit in Vegas, but I don't like to dress up. Because remember when I was young, I didn't have nothing. I always stood on me. So I always realized I don't need to dress up. Now I have nice things that look nice on me, but I'm not dressing to watch this.
You ain't gonna wear no tuxedo.
Right. Well, no. I'm not dressing to impress because I'm impressive, motherfucker. I don't stand in my clothes. You see what I'm saying? I'm not gonna dress to impress. That's not my job. I'm just gonna wear if I'm wearing my polo, I wear my mother little Docker joints. Wear my Nikes, my Nike socks. Yeah, you know, yeah. I have a little fun. You know, I gotta have my Nike like shit. You know, I even wear my little Nike flip flops with my Nike socks on. I got my Nike flip flops. My Nike socks. Yeah, I don't mind. I don't need. I don't need clothes.
I mean, that's true. Yeah. You're not following by the rules that you know.
Because I am the rule. I am the rule. I'm the law. I'm the code. I am all that stuff. Does that make any sense?
Yeah, it makes perfect sense, man.
So yeah, so yes.
All right, so what the thing is like about that subconscious and conscious, like has she been traumatized,
all right, watch this. A woman has been traumatized, okay? This is let me show you how game works. Game is not forcing her to face her trauma. Game is not thinking or talking about the trauma. Game is all about her feeling safe enough around you to take small steps to hit and reach a certain goal. We're not. Listen, a lot, there are women out there who have trauma, right? Okay.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
What I'm saying is, I'm not here to talk you through your trauma like a therapist, but I'm here to show you that you can trust me enough to realize that whatever you have that is a trauma that you're worried about, I can promise you with me that you don't have to worry about that. Remember, I don't talk about it. I'm about it. I be about it. Do you see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Does that make
sense? Yeah.
So I mean, what do you understand?
So basically, when you say be about it, is the action that you're putting out.
Well, yeah, but what is? But how are you breaking that down, though? I'm saying what is that to you, though? What is that to you? Then I'll tell you what it is to me. What is that to you? Because what I learned at 9.
I'm gonna tell you. To me, putting into action and being about it is really just showing her yourself and just, you know, doing moments for her, basically. You know what I mean?
No, that's it. You already lost.
Oh, all right. What's yours?
For me, I learned at 9 as a student of the game. Is that I'm not pursuing, it has nothing to do with her. I am consciously trying to, okay, so I at 9, I had a seed, okay? Mm-hmm. And that seed was a pursuit of me. And I what I did is I dug that hole and put that seed in there. But I had to pursue me and be dedicated to me. And how I gave myself water and light was to set a high standard for my motherfucking self and work actively towards reaching and fucking surpassing any standard that I had, because I was never satisfied. So I was always focusing on my personal growth, right? And at the same time, with my blacksmith and my culinary school and my drug lab, to hone in on my skills of, I had to build that building of a building of romance, a building of being smooth, a building of being seductive, a building of being sensual, a building of being freaky, a building of being dirty. So I had to create all these damn buildings and hone on my skills and expand not the knowledge of the world. I had to drink from my own fountain to learn me and expand my knowledge from myself to improve not only my my performance, big dog, but also the outcomes that I get, dog. I committed to myself, because remember, the game ain't about women, and that's why when if I'm sitting across or beside her, I'm not worried about anything, because my pursuit of me, the commitment that I have for myself, there are no boundaries. There are no challenges. But I am always seeking opportunities in myself to learn more about me by drinking more of my knowledge from my fountain, because I am the only one of me, right? Which kills everybody else, because everybody else is drinking from the manosphere and they're drinking from other guys. I'm saying fuck everybody else. I'm saying that I am one thought, one mind, one way. And I had to learn through my knowledge that I am one word of one, one letter of one word of one sentence of a paragraph of several paragraphs and several chapters of many books. So that's game. So that's why they don't have a program on me. The only way you can have a program on me or create one is to be around me. If that makes any sense.
Okay. Question. So, when you said when you had to build the romance, all that, you know, build it all yourself. Did you have to do it yourself, or?
This is what I'm saying. Okay, so, okay, romance. Okay, let's take something romantic. Okay, so, I had to sit down. I had to literally sit down and really talk to myself. And by talking to myself, what did I say for myself? I said, okay, I have to learn how should I kiss her? If I'm going to kiss a woman, How can I do it in a romantic way? See that? So then that starts everything. So then scribe, my scribe. All right, a scribe. It's not the kiss. It's the buildup, the kiss, and then after. See, that's how deep game is. It's not just, I'm just going to lean over and kiss you. I want to build it up. But then there lies more questions of how do I want to build it up? Do I want to look at her first? Do I want to touch her first? Do I want to say something in her ear? What do I remember? I have many, many ways to kiss. And I'm just giving an example. But most people don't think this deep. They think just leaning in and just kissing her. No, there's going to be a before, a kiss, and an after already set in stone by how I created it. And then once, hey, wait, get ready. Once I create that motherfucker, what do you think I'm doing? Once I create that idea, where do you think I'm going next? Where do you think the next place I'm going once I have the idea?
You embedded in?
No, I mean, where do you think I'm going next? Where do you think I'm going next?
After what? You scribing stuff?
Yeah, no, wait. No. Once I figure out that after I scribe it, then mm-hmm. guess what? I'm going to my marketing team. How am I going to market what I'm about to do? And to make sure I got it down right, I go into my mental studio, right? I've got to arrange it, compose it, produce it, perform it. So I got it all locked down. So then when I make that motherfucker a law in which I abide by, then it's just going, I got it. There is no nerve because they've never met anyone like me before. So I'm going to be new at all this shit. I'm going to be a new experience. Because most guys don't think that deep. Does that make any sense?
Yeah, that makes a lot of sense. All right. Well, that's all I need to know, Steve. Well, make perfect sense, you know?
Well, I try to make sense all sometimes.
Right.
All right. All right, so you got any questions, let me know. All right, respect. All right, we'll throw you back in. Thank you, sir. Area code 559, sir. How can I help you, sir? What's up? 559, sir. What's going
on?
Yes, sir. Can you turn down your speaker, please? We can't hear you.
Yeah. Yes, can you hear me now?
Yes, sir. How can I help you, sir?
Hey, Steve. So I got this girl. She's been asking when I'm free and shit, right? She's been saying she likes how straightforward I am. Super straightforward, and that's what. Because the day I approach her at.
Okay, stop. Stop right there. Let's go deep because I know you don't have the answer, but tell me, what's the move? What's the play?
The move is I'm finna take her. We finna go to the park, and I'm gonna just let her.
I'm lost. What you said that she thought you were deep in all these other things, right?
No, she said she likes how super straightforward I am based off of the first interactions, which kind of swept her off her feet because she was fresh out.
So real quick, here's the question. Why isn't the second date at your place or her place if you swept her off her feet?
You're right.
Well, it's not about
I was just about to get to it right now.
Well, what I'm saying is that you're talking about take her walk around and shit. Then you're fucking it up. You gotta
It's not to walk around. It's because she keeps telling me she don't want nothing super serious. So that's when I'm about to hit her
Well, here's what I don't understand. Wait. This is what I don't understand. Where is I don't want anything serious with her? Why is she telling you what the fuck she wants? Why aren't you who are supposed you? Okay, there's something wrong here because if you're that straightforward, she should already know what the fuck you are, what she is, and what y'all are together. Why doesn't she know that?
Right. So that means she's fresh off a breakup. Brother, she's trying to be closed up to me, you know.
Brother, wait,
you get what I'm saying?
No, I don't get what you're saying. Because listen, okay, if I'm dealing with a woman that's fresh off a breakup, regardless if she's off a breakup or not, I'm not trying to move at my own fucking pace. But I'm gonna tell you this: I'm not looking for anything serious. Because here's the problem: I know if you get with me, you're gonna fucking fall in love with me. I listen. What I keep telling you?
Yeah.
I don't want to be your friend.
Exactly.
I don't want you to be attracted to me.
She wants she's going to be the one who wants me based off of what I'm going to let her know.
Right, but you're not
when we interact in person.
But you're not letting her, you're not leading with your standard. She should never say to you, I don't want anything serious. You should have had told her that I don't want anything serious because you just came out of a breakup. And you know what? I'm not trying to pressure you to do anything. Do you see what I'm saying?
Yeah, I'm not going to force you to do nothing you don't want to. Okay, I'm here to have fun. You know?
Okay, yeah. When she said I didn't want anything serious, what did you say after that, big dog?
Let me see. Let me go to it real quick.
All right.
Okay, she said, when are you free? ? I actually like how straightforward you are, but I am telling you, I'm not looking for nothing serious. I just got out of a year-long relationship. I said, let's just have a little fun then. Nothing crazy. I know you're trying to get your mind right, so I'm not looking. I'm also not looking to rush
anything.
Okay,
you're not. No, there you go. You're lying now because now you're just trying to say some shit. That's bullshit. All that's bullshit. If you don't want anything serious, that's cool.
I need to let her know.
Remember what's the rule of Jill Scott?
Shit.
Okay, you don't know the rule of Jill Scott. I'm gonna show you the rule of Jill Scott, and I'm gonna connect.
I remember you said the other day. Yeah.
You should always know this rule. Here you go.
I say it like this: if you can tell me what to do, mm-hmm. then you can tell me what to do. But if you can't tell me what to do, you can't tell me what to do.
Damn. So she's saying, I don't want anything serious. That's cool. I love the connection. I love spending time with you. And I would love to have you. I would love to have you over my place this day, this time. And I would like to move this thing forward and see what happens.
Okay,
but see, you're not doing that. You're not.
I'm trying to beat around the bush.
You can't do that, dog.
I didn't realize it at first, but now it's clicking.
You can't do that shit.
She said, "I'll see if I can around what time." Because I told her I'm already going on a. I'm going on a ride later with the homie on the bike, so I'll hit you up. We could probably shoot some hoops or some shit. And she said that she's busy. She said, good afternoon now. Sorry, I'm so busy at work. So I told her, I was like, just probably between 7 or 8 if that works for you.
Okay, brother. You do understand they take lunch breaks, right?
That was the first day I got.
I'm giving you the rope and you're killing yourself. She's saying that I'm busy all day. So you know what? Hey, baby, listen. I know you're busy and all this other stuff. And I know you're having a long day. Hey, when you have some time at your break or some free time, get back at me because I want to see you later on tonight at my place.
But
remember, don't push sex. It's not coming over to fuck. It's coming over because because if she challenges you on that, you know why? I'm not that kind of girl. I said, wait a second. I didn't say to come over to have sex with me. I'm just saying to move this forward.
I'm
not that guy to move this thing forward because, like you said before, you're not looking for anything serious. Nor am I. I'm not looking at anything serious, but the last thing I want to do is waste your time or my time.
Okay.
Do you see what I'm saying?
I get you what you're saying, fam. So I'm gonna just let her know straight up since
because
there were some two surface dwellers next year the very first time I approached her. But I kept it pushing because she didn't want to give me the number. So I kept shopping after I got my money order for the rent. And she came back up to me with her phone out with the number, with the keypad saying, my bad. It was just awkward on the clock because I didn't really need the other two guys chiming in. But I didn't really say nothing at the time, which I should have. But basically, I was giving it to her straight how it is, you know?
But you're not leading.
Yeah.
You see what I'm saying?
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm not, right. I'm saying to you is that, okay, you don't want anything serious, but I do want to see you and I want to spend some time with you. And listen, yeah. I'm trying to bring you into my amusement park.
Okay.
You know what I mean? I want you to come over. Look, listen, we can sit, we can chill, we can have a relaxing evening and see where it takes us. That's all. And have her come over and shit. Yeah. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah. For sure. Because I do. Now it's clicking, because why would I hold that shit back if I ain't even worried about what she thinks? I'm supposed to be worried about what I'm thinking.
Well, yeah, but no, I'm respecting what her boundary is. She doesn't want anything serious. But I'm saying I don't want anything serious. I just want to spend a little time with you and see where it goes from there. But you gotta lead her to that point. Don't allow her to run shit. You see what I'm saying?
Okay.
Yeah.
So what would be the best option?
Look, brother, you want to call her right now and tell her something? I'd tell you what to say. I mean, I can show you what to say. This is a layup.
Nah, hell yeah, because probably won't answer. Well, I already tried to do that the first time, but I'm down to do it again. I gotta leave her a voice message for her to read it.
Right, leave her a voice message. Leave her a message on the phone.
Okay, voice text.
Yeah, not a text. Call her phone, and when her phone answers, leave her. I'll tell you what to say.
Okay, hold up. Let me write it down real quick.
All right, I got you.
What's up, my guy?
Because
FMA session one just been having me on a whole new.
We gotta operate. Yeah, we gotta tap into that sexual side of you too, man. Because you gotta be be smooth with that shit.
You're right.
So all I want you to say is this. All I want you to say is this. Okay. Is that listen? I enjoyed spending whatever you were together with her. I enjoyed spending that time with you, right?
Yeah.
And if you're free tonight or tomorrow, you choose it. You're king. I would love for you to come over to my place and we just sit back and chill.
Okay.
And that's it. We just simplified. We don't need to go all the way out there. Just simplify. But the difference is you're leading.
Yeah, I'm going to lead her right where I want her with you. And not for no manipulator or none of that.
Right. And like you said, nothing serious. This is us spending a little time. That's it. That's all we're going to do is spend some time together and see what happens at that point.
So, I enjoy spending that little bit amount of time with you that we had at Walmart.
Yeah.
And since I'm free tonight, I would love to invite you over to my spot and we could just hang out.
No, wait. No, I didn't say fucking hang out. I didn't say that bullshit.
Okay. I thought we could just get back, or what did you say?
We spend some time together. Fuck that hang out shit. See, now you being friend zoning.
And we'll spend some time together.
Yeah, spend some time together. Leave that door open, dog. You just close that motherfucker and lock that bitch, dog. You're talking about hang out. The fuck you gonna do? Hang out well with you? No. Let's spend some time together and see. And we'll see what happens after that. Cause I don't want you to waste no time, man.
Yeah, you're right. So I enjoyed some time with you the short amount of time we had together at Walmart, and
you didn't spend your time at Walmart with her, did you?
Okay. That was the very first day I approached her, and she was like, I guess 10 hours off of a breakup or some shit like that.
All right, just
because she worked.
Well, just call her and leave her that message. I got to continue. Just call her and leave her that message. Got to continue with the show. Just call her and leave her that message and see what happens. Okay, my brother.
Okay, we'll send some. Since I'm free tonight. I'd love to have you over so we could spend some time together.
No, I would like to have you over at this specifics. I would love to have you over at this time.
Okay.
Come to my place at this time. Don't be afraid. Okay. And remember, like you said, it's nothing serious. We're just going to see what happens. We'll let whatever happens, okay. Happens. Okay?
Yeah. All right, and I'll let her know that, right?
Yeah, or... you let her know, my brother, okay?
Okay.
All right. Good call, man. We'll throw you back in. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Good call. Lines are open, guys. This is the Dean Man Mindset. Let me see. What is it? Yeah, real quick, gentlemen. I want to show you a text testimonial from someone that just sent this over to me. And I want to show you guys this because I want you guys to see what happens when they will get mad at you. Well, not mad at you, but they will challenge you as a man. And when they challenge you as a man, it's very important to let them go. Okay. How many times have I told you guys, sometimes you just got to charge these motherfuckers to the game and let them go. Right. And let me show you this. It's only like four of them. It's not many, but I'm just going to show you these four. And we'll make a testimonial out of it. But I just want to show you guys the power of game. So if you look at this right here, this is what she said right here. She said, good morning. Now look at the date. I want y'all to see the date. I want you to see the date. This is in April. So we're talking about April, May, June, July. 3 months. Okay, I want to show y'all how cold game is. So what did she say? Okay, this has nothing to do with catching feelings. If anything, I became disinterested in you. And what did he say? Understandable. Okay. You also don't seem to have time. They're looking for, okay, they broke off for 3 months. And all he did was say what's good to her, right? That's all he said to her. And what did she say? Get back. Now, let's follow it. Listen, she's saying, Nick, she said, okay. He said, hey, stranger, what's good? And look, gentlemen, always remember that even if they run away, no matter how long they run away, when you talk to them, it's going to feel like y'all just never missed a beat. And what happened right here? I've been thinking about you. Come pick me up. Now, remember, I want to show you. Remember, this is the woman in April that said, fuck, I'm done with you. And all he did was just reach out to her and say, hey, what's up, stranger? Okay? And then he asked where he at. She said she was home. Okay, I'm going to link up with one of my fam in the city, and I can come pick you up. And she simply said at that point right there, she said, okay, just text me before. You're on my way, 10 minutes, address, en route. Okay, she said she's at the barrel. Bet, see you there soon. How soon is soon? I'm ready. I mean, this is what I'm saying. I'm ready is ready, and then here you go. All this is the same. Pulling up in 2 minutes, give me a sec. What does that mean? I'm a mile away here, coming in the car. And all of this gentleman stems from her saying that, again, challenge. But remember, that's why we send them back out to the world to other guys. Gentlemen, always push them towards the other guys because they're going to feel that they have the top spot, top position because they have all these guys running behind them, and they think that they can just say something to you and walk the fuck off and walk away. And you just got to say to them, okay, goodbye. I see you when I see you. And he just gave her a crumb. All he did was hit her with a crumb. And when he hit her with the crumb, everything just kicked right back in. So, gentlemen, I just want to show y'all how the game works when you have game. And as long as you guys do that, you're not going to have any problems. You're not going to have any issues or any complications or anything like that. Everything's going to fall in place and flow. Let me get some of y'all questions, guys. Lines are open because we are continuing and chopping it up. Let me grab some of your questions that you have. What type of food is the best food to cook on the first engagement? I wouldn't cook any food. I win if it's the first engagement. You don't need to cook on the first time. You don't need to cook. Do you even bring plates of silverware first engagement? No. You don't. No, it's the first engagement. You shouldn't do that. You shouldn't. Excuse me. You shouldn't do that anyway. Thank you for. I appreciate that. No, absolutely not. You should not. First engagement. You shouldn't have to cook. You don't need to cook. It's not something that you need to do. But anyway, gentlemen, getting back to what I'm saying, guys, lines are open if y'all have any questions. But as I was saying to you guys to soak up the game and all this other stuff, is that what we're saying to you guys out here is that when you create and expand your knowledge of the game, okay, and the concept of how you do it will change everything with the woman, because at that point, you're not looking at the fear. You're not. Oh, God, I have a feeling. Is this California? What's up, big dog? I mean, what's up, Anonymous? I don't know if this is my guy. What's up?
Ladies, quick question. With the travel drawer for when females spend the night and do sleepovers, can we do we got to put perfume in there? And if we tap into the mouthwash, is that cool, or do we want to leave it untouched?
What are you talking about?
I remember a while ago you said about putting the travel shit for when women come over, like travel mouthwash. Yes. Travel.
Well, you don't have to have a, you don't have to have a perfume. No, what I'm saying, in the drawer, you should have makeup wipes. You should have a toothbrush, toothpaste, shampoo, conditioner. You know, just those little things in the drawer.
Got it. All right. Check. Fucking check that on my crayons right now. Hey, throw him back in deep. Give him a fist bump.
Right.
And yeah, dude, this fucking that submarine thing, I said, I wasn't lying, dude. When I'm around her friend, she brings along this bitch who fucking makes chicken coop, and she tries to make me feel so insignificant. So I'm not going on a date with that woman again if she brings her friend. So throw him back in, and she likes women, you know. She's one of those, like, looks like a dude, and she's fucking, oh, right. I can make chicken coops. You're not good with the impact drill. I'm like, fuck you.
No, it's all good. All right, we'll throw you back in. Okay, thanks, brother. Guys, the lines are open if you guys have a question. We got y'all covered, but we're breaking all this down. And what we hold on a second. Okay, there we go. All right, so what I'm saying to you guys out here, this is what comes into what I was saying. When you guys create the standard for yourself, gentlemen, it is at that point that there is no what's the worst that can happen. Okay, we get 347. 347, sir, how can I help you, sir? What's up?
Hey, Steve.
Yes, sir.
I was listening to your call, the panel earlier.
Yes, sir.
And you guys were talking about how everybody on the panel got their own style.
Yes.
So my question is, when you don't have the judgments and you don't think outside yourself and you rehearse yourself, that means your own style will formulate by itself?
No, it doesn't work that way. No. Okay. So you need to be a student of the game, because you don't understand the style is okay. All right. Right now, you are either in the I can't, the I won't, which means you're in your feelings, or you're in the I do, which means you're looking to the outside world. So anything you create is going to be based upon a weak foundation or based upon emotions. So anything you do is not going to help you. That's why you need a mentor to keep you rooted and learn how to root yourself in yourself. Okay?
Okay.
You see what I'm saying? To root you in you. So once you are rooted in you, then it's at that point you become a student, because then at that point you start to soak up knowledge. See, remember, you're not soaking up knowledge or anything because you don't believe that you have a fountain of knowledge that you can tap into that is going to expand your mind. You're not there yet. So anything
you mean the untapped knowledge of yourself.
Right, but you're not there yet. So anything you're doing right now is you're trying to tap into somebody else's thing. Do you see what I'm saying?
Yeah, that's what I meant. Like when you're thinking outside of, when you're not thinking outside of yourself and you don't have judgment, but you rehearse yourself, that's all inside of you. So your own style will formulate off of that.
What do what now?
Like, so when you're not thinking outside yourself and you don't have the judgments that you talk about,
mm-hmm.
and you rehearse yourself, then when you have all that down pat, your own style will formulate based off your own knowledge.
Well, but you don't know what the knowledge is. Does that mean Does it make any sense?
Yeah, I understand what you're saying.
So what I'm saying, okay. I'm saying is that right now you're just on the outside looking in because you're not a student yet. You don't know. You don't have understanding of understanding. You don't have any knowledge of yourself. You don't even know yourself. You don't have any idea how great you are because you are not actually putting in the time to become great. So all you're doing is just watching shows. That's cool. But bird watching is not being a student of the game.
I understand what you're saying.
Okay.
Thank you. Thank you.
Okay.
Thank you.
Okay.
All right.
All right, brother. Thank you.
Yep.
All right. All right. Okay, guys, lines are open, and that's what I'm saying, guys. What I'm saying to all you guys out there, soak up the game. Now, as I was saying before, getting back to how you think and how you move and all this other stuff. See, the thing is, gentlemen, the thing about game, okay, is everything that you do, you're not soaking in the knowledge and allowing the experiences to be an opportunity to see and make adjustments in, okay? And that's why most of you guys are not mentally prepared, okay? Because you just wait for life to happen versus controlling the life, moving. But the clarity, see, the problem is one cannot move off of just sex. If I ask you guys to clarify what you want, most of you guys will say, I just want some ass, okay? That's all you would say, I just want some ass, okay? And what I'm saying is that for a man, the clarification is not the sex that comes with the game. I'm saying, what are the preparations that you are making to start figuring out what you're going to do, how you're going to do it, how you're going to move. So let me show you the clarification, okay? Clarification. When you guys, okay, when I ask you guys a question, what is it that you want? And I'm not going to knock you guys for any, like, you just want sex. I'm not doing that. What I'm trying to get you guys to see that as a student of the game, the clarification is nothing to do with the woman. The clarification is the communication between you and how you're moving. If all it is you want just a piece of ass, there are no whys. You can't stand on it, defend, or express because you're just showing your thirst and the lack of experience you have. But what we will do and how we will move and how we think and how we go, okay? We're saying to you guys out here that I again, my dog right here, my brother from another mother who got nothing but game, no one better. I'll use my dogs when they roll in this motherfucker. No one better sees a woman, he ain't thinking about the pussy because the pussy's gonna come. He ain't thinking that I've got to run behind her and kiss her ass. But I can promise you without giving out any information that I can promise you that the women are so intrigued by him that they're talking about you guys. I've never met anyone like you. Most guys, ready? Most guys are thirsty. Most guys are begging. Most guys are trying to manipulate. Most guys are trying to do this. And then she's going to say, but what is different about you, or my dog, no one better. What's different is that you're not moving that way. Because if you look at better, and I was showing y'all, because every move no one better does is he knows the why. He knows how to express. And if he's ever challenged, he can defend the position because he's standing on this motherfucking square. And that's the difference between us and you guys and keeping her, okay? Keeping her in your orbit and her wanting to be there. Let me bring in area code 832. 832, what's up, man? Yes, sir, how can I help you?
Hey, what's going on, Dean? I was calling to see.
Wait, sir. Can you get off the out of the speaker, please?
Oh shit! Hold on.
Yeah. Okay. You iPhone users? Sound like you're on an iPhone. So go ahead.
No, I'm on an Android.
No, you can't be, man. Stop that shit. I got an Android. Stop that. Hurry up and get off the speakerphone. You're making me look bad.
Nah, but I got the Bluetooth.
Oh, can you take that off and just go on your phone? Because you said, there you go. Sound, oh, now you sound
yeah,
better.
Yeah, I got you. You okay. Now?
Yes, go ahead. What's your question?
Yeah, no, I just really wanted to know what days you in 1950 be doing the pineapple show, man? Because I kind of ran across it on accident, but I've been fucking with it. I said, man, these dudes be having a good time with that shit.
Wednesday.
Every Wednesday?
Yes.
Okay. And I actually called in one day, man. I talked to the girl in the back end, but, you know, these women be having like 100,000 likes and followers and shit like that. Not that that matters, but in their little world, you know, she responded back. We had a little dialogue, but she wasn't really talking about shit. So we kept it moving, man.
Yeah. Well, that's cool then. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. No, what's your question though?
Really, I just want to know about the situation when y'all call in. You said Wednesday, so that's really the number one question. But any game on, you know, trying to spice stuff up in a monogamous relationship?
Well, the spice is that you got to learn yourself. It's not learning the woman, because you can bring something to her that she's never had before. So that's why I would say for you, you know, learn. We've got kissing, eating pussy, kissing, making out, fucking, talking dirty. So you just got to learn some of that stuff. I would say just move there, big dog.
Yeah, because I've been trying to incorporate like little staycations here and there. You know what I'm saying? Like you get a little, you know, rent a little hotel. Not really deck it out with no flowers, but every now and then get a hotel. We do a little, you know, bring some food in, a little room service, a little pool. Just switching it up. Because, you know, when you with somebody for a long time, that shit can be kind of boring laying down with their ass every night and shit like that. So I know you guys be having different little women like that.
Yeah. I'm just saying, no, it's all love. It's all love. You know what I mean?
All right. Well, keep doing your thing, man. I'll catch y'all later, man. But I'm going to catch y'all Wednesday for sure, man.
Okay. We appreciate that. Okay. That's what I'm saying. Okay. All right. It's all love. Right. It's all respect, man. Thank you. Thank you. What I'm saying. Okay. Okay. So, all right. We'll let you go. Hold on. All right. So, guys, the line's open. If you have any questions, we got y'all covered. He was using the Android, and it wasn't that I wish he's making us Android guys look bad. But anyway, you know, I always talk shit about you iPhone motherfuckers. Come on, man. You got to fix the Bluetooth. You're making us look bad. But anyway, what I'm saying to you guys out here is to clarify what it is that you want. And you got to figure out what you want to do. And you got to make sure that everything is out here. This is why, again, I'm going to use my dog, No One Better. The desired outcome is not what he's looking for, because he is the outcome. So whatever happens from that point, he's the second to the last domino. The outcome is going to happen after he presents himself to her and gives her the opportunity to make the choice. But again, before he does all of that, he's looking at the obstacles that he's going to face. What are the obstacles he's going to face? He's going to face her belief system, her morals, her judgment, and trust. Those are the obstacles. He knows that automatically, okay? What resources is he going to use, tools, skills that is going to help him by standing on his motherfucking square and his principle and not moving off of that by showing any kind of weakness? He's going to be one thought, one mind, one way. He knows how to acquire the resources because he drinks from his knowledge. He is his own resource. That's what we're trying to show you guys. You must learn how to tap into your own resource and then know what to do when the time presents itself. And that means that you're either going to do it or not waste your fucking time, or you're going to go forward, or listen, I keep trying to tell all you guys, and I'll use Better. We don't waste our fucking time. We do not wait. Gentlemen, I'm telling you, you think these women waste their time? Do you think these women waste their time? Do you know they cut you motherfuckers off like that, right? They don't waste time. Eric code 3310, sir. What's going on, brother? How can I help you, brother? What's going on?
Yo, what's up, Steve? I made a little statement for myself, and I'd love to get your feedback on it.
Let's hear the statement, brother. What you got?
So does this make any sense? This is like a little checklist for myself whatever. So it says facial hair, smell, posture, attitude, character, produce, mix, fun, play,
free.
What is this for?
Canvas.
Wait, stop. What is this for?
Painting art.
Wait, what is this for?
This is for approaching girls.
We don't approach women. We put our bid in, man.
Hmm.
All right, let me ask you a question. What's 3 plus 3?
It is 6.
What is 12 divided by 6?
Oh, shit, you're getting crazy.
12 divided by 6.
Yeah. 3.
No, not 3. 2. 12 divided by 6. Yeah, 2. Okay. So what I'm saying is how did you get to that point of knowing adding, subtracting, multiplying, and division? You see, here's your problem. You didn't go in and write a list of things. You learn things. See, you're just, okay, everything you're saying is from the surface. You're not really about that. You're just saying a bunch of things to do, which is fine. But then when you get into the game and you get around a woman, you ain't going to look at that list, because that list doesn't have it's not rooted in anything, brother. The list. Okay. Give me something that way. Give me two things that you're saying. Give me two of those things.
Smell. That would be like the customer service, right? When I'm talking to a woman.
Smell. But what are you smelling? Like, what do you mean smell? Smell. No, what?
The smell I'm giving off.
Wait. What do you mean this fucking smell you're giving off? Dog. Okay, stop. Are you joking right now? Are you're trying to figure out the smell you're giving off? What does that mean?
No, I'm saying like that's just the icing on the cake.
But what do you, okay, when you're saying smell, what does that mean? What does that mean to you? I don't understand. You said smell. Like, what smell are you giving off?
I feel like it indirectly, in a way, sets the tone.
What? Okay, like, what smell?
Oh, like I'm going to be probably wearing like some bourbon shit from Old Spice. I don't know.
Okay, brother. Old Spice is so 1980s. I hope you're not wearing. No, I hope you're not wearing Old Spice.
Put me on.
Okay. All right. What you need to do is go to Macy's or Dillard's tomorrow and go to the cologne section and try out some colognes that smell nice. Old Spice is like 1980. That's 1980. Word.
Okay.
Yes. So, please listen. Why do you think your smell? No, I know Allure. Hey, you know I'm team Allure. My Allure, I will wear that shit for the end of time. I love Allure. But I'm just saying, what is your smell supposed to do? What is your smell supposed to give off?
I feel like I was lacking. My whole paragraph essay thesis statement was lacking was the word Allure.
Said Old Spice. You didn't say Allure. You said Old Spice.
No, but the actual definition of allure is to like attract.
I'm saying allure. That's my cologne. No, my cologne is called. Right.
I'm not with the brand.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. Not no Old Spice. That's so 1980s. No, what I'm saying to you is this. What is your scent supposed to do? Draw her in to do what? To say you smell good?
It's supposed to create some type of thought in her head.
Okay, stop. You've got to get this fucking fairy tale shit out of your system. Why do you think by smelling good, she's automatically going to have this thought of something? Why? What? Why do you think of that?
Because, gathered information, because I really fuck with your content. Gather information for what I'm piecing together is
no,
like,
but you're piecing it. Okay, wait. Okay. You have level one thinking. So, what do you think you're piecing everything together on? What level?
Like level people one. Don't know what
sir,
the
you're not,
shit is.
Sir, you're so not listening. You're not listening. Again, your level one thinking. You think because I smell good, she's automatically going to think what? What is she supposed to think?
This guy knows something I don't.
That has nothing to do with what you smell like. It doesn't have, I'm not saying smell bad, but why would you use that? Have you ever heard me tell you that your smell is going to make her think that you're the guy?
No, so but then, I feel like...
No, wait. So, okay, wait. It's wait, a wait, part wait, wait, wait. Time out, time out, time out. I'm going to use what you said. You feel like... So, again, if your thoughts are level one and you have a feel like thought, is it a 10 or a 1?
It's a 1, right?
Right. So, then let's throw that out the way. Put a scratch that out. That's terrible. What's the next thing? What's the next thing you're thinking?
In regards to what?
No, body. Your next list. What's the next thing? You said your smell, then what's the next thing?
Okay, let me go to it real quick. Hold on. All right, so posture.
Where's your your posture? Okay, what about your posture?
Just stand up straight because you want to have a hunched back or not.
So,
like that.
But what is that supposed to do though? Yeah, you should. But what is that supposed to do? Why do you care about your posture? But what is that supposed to do?
Embrace confidence for myself because.
But you can't embrace what you're not. Okay, brother. You can't embrace something that you're not. You're embracing femininity. You're not bracing. Okay. All right. Okay, brother. Okay. Do you ever hear me saying I'm embracing my confidence or am I just confident? No, I'm asking a question. Do you? Okay. You heard of Michael Jordan, right?
Yeah.
Does Michael Jordan, when he was playing basketball, did every time he shot a shot, did he go and look in the camera like, yeah, I'm Michael Jordan. I'm confident.
No.
No. Where was Michael Jordan's confidence at? Where do you think Michael Jordan's confidence are, but where do you think his confidence was at?
It was in his head, right?
No, it wasn't in his head.
All right. On the court.
No, it wasn't on the court.
Well, okay, you broke my algorithm.
Okay, I'm about to break your algorithm. Now, follow me on this. Follow me. This is deep. His confidence was not in his head or in the court. His confidence is what he did on the back end. But the end result of the work he did on the back end is what you saw on TV. While you were
how to get there,
but no, because he was working on himself. He was taking shot after shot after shot. He was working on his dribbling skills. He was exercising. He was working on his car. He was doing a bunch of shit on the back end. So what you saw was the end result of confidence. The confidence was created.
How he got there?
Yeah, the confidence is always created in what you do while no one else is around. Working on yourself. That's what game is. You guys see the end result of what we do. So you think you want to do what we're doing, but you don't understand what we did on the back end to get what we're doing. You just see the end result.
All right.
So what I'm saying is everything you're writing is going to fail because there is nothing you're doing on the back end to be a student of the game and learn game.
Okay.
Does that make any sense though, big guy?
Yeah, complete sense. And
yeah. So listen. No. Don't beat yourself up because see, that's what your mind does to fuck you over. Let me write a list, kind of like what y'all do on December. Let me tell myself something, or let me write a list. I don't do that. What do you think I do? I talk to my scribe. I talk to my marketing team. I talk to my culinary school. Let me find ways to create dishes, ways to touch, ways to kiss, ways to talk, ways to move. See, I do all that shit on the back end. I create my world. So my end result is not my, you don't see, you see a man, but the man was created behind the scenes, brother. You just see an end result of a motherfucker that believes in himself. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
No. And no, stop. Hold on and pause real quick. That's what losers do. because you can be a buffed up sucker. You can, and the problem is, you guys that put work into the gym, you're fucking up. Because you're putting work in, hold on, Carl. I got to tell someone this guy. Let me chin check this bullshit he's saying. Your problem is that the work, well, no, not you. I'm just talking to him. The work, that's what you go wrong. You're not putting like M1 like said, you ain't working on your mental gym. You working just lifting some fucking weights and shit. But anyway, call it. But does that make any sense though, what I'm saying to you?
Yeah. Going off of what you said right there, I used to be fat and shit.
Stop. I know a bunch of fat motherfuckers that are fucking beautiful women right now. I'm talking about a big ass cut. And these women are crying over these guys. They're begging for the dick and their time.
That sounds like, why does my mind think that's a lie?
Because your mind ain't shit. Because your mind is on a... Okay, I'll give you an example. Have you ever watched The Sopranos?
No.
You've never watched The Sopranos at all?
I just seen it and I was like, nah, I ain't fucking with it.
Okay.
Mind is whack.
What I'm saying to you that you don't understand, Big Dog, what I'm saying to you is this, is that I don't give a fuck if you're fat, skinny, short, or tall. A man is not represented by his body. And the fact, because you have no game, you want to give me a sob story of you being big, but I've just told you, I know a bunch of big motherfuckers who are doing all kind of fucking, but your mind cannot process that, because if your mind processed it, you would then know that you're the fucking problem. And I'm not knocking you for that. I'm saying to you, wait a second, hold on, wait, let me ask you a question. Have you watch porn, right? I'm sure you watch porn. We all watch porn. So do you not see fat See, this is what's wrong with you, dog. Why can't you fucking be honest? I'm hanging this phone up. I don't like wasting my time.
Okay,
so
I'm
gonna laugh and goof off. I'm gonna move the fuck on. So it's okay. So don't you see guys of all different races, creeds, colors, heights, sizes, them fucking women? Are they not fucking? Yeah. Are they not?
Yeah.
So what does your size have to do anything? Tell me, what does your size have to do anything?
Nothing at all, but it makes you better than the others.
You say it makes you better than the others?
It makes you stand out in comparison.
Fuck you. No, not you, caller. No, I'm sorry. I was just had my boy is always fucking iPhone. All right. So no, it doesn't make you better because you don't feel that you're better. See, listen. Okay, listen. I have a little gut. Do you think that stops me? Do you think motherfuckers who have guts, do you think that stops them from getting women?
It didn't stop me.
But no. Stop that, because you're fucking lying right now, because you were crying about how fat you used to be. So stop
it
that shit.
It has stopped me.
Then why are you lying? Okay, look, I'm going to let you go because I feel like you're bullshitting around. I got time for games. When you're ready to be a man, call back, brother. Call back. I got to let you go. I don't see why y'all see this. The problem. A lot of y'all guys take this shit as a joke. A lot of y'all guys are playing around and y'all not taking it seriously. And that's why y'all are fucking losing. And I'm a winner. Motherfuckers I hang out with are winners. And we don't play with this shit. This shit is serious. Y'all got to start taking this shit serious, because I'm not the one that's nervous. I'm not the one. I don't stand on my clothes or anything like that. What the fuck, man? What is that? What do you want, sir?
Yo, what's up, Dean? I'm calling back because I want to shut my mouth and get blessed.
What is your question? I got to move on. What is your question, dog? Ask your question. I answer and I move on. What's your question?
All right. So my baby mama, I tried to break up my baby mama. She seems like she don't want to do that route. So I'm just gonna quote unquote.
How old are you?
I'm 26. She's 27.
I don't give a fuck. Why don't you put on your big boy pants, break up with the bitch, and move on? What is the?
Because she's homeless.
Okay, sir. Please cry me a fucking river. Does she not have parents?
One of them is dead and her parents is homeless.
Let me ask you, why do you hate yourself? Why would you?
Myself.
No. Only a bitch is gonna fuck a homeless chick and have a kid by her.
She wasn't homeless. She practically is my age. I met her in school.
Your job is to take care of your child.
Yeah.
Why are you living with a woman that you don't want to be with?
Literally makes my life a living hell where my choices are better off where I use her.
Sir, what? Guys like you just fuck everything up.
Fuck. For real?
You knew she wasn't shit.
Yeah, I did know that.
Okay.
You're right.
Okay, dog. Look. I'm just go to the manosphere and just complain about women. This ain't for you. You ain't ready to be a man.
Nah, I ain't trying to do that.
No, if you're ready to be a man, get coaching. No, you're not. I can't deal with you. If you need coaching, call me.
Get an appointment? All right.
Get an appointment. I can't. Goodbye. I can't. I try. I can't. And y'all want, and then y'all always want to complain about women. And then y'all want to call them modern and talk all this shit. And you should not be getting someone pregnant that is not going to carry the name, dude. Come on, stop that silly shit. Anyway, man, let's get back to the show. Guys, you got questions. I got y'all covered. It's the man mindset. But what I'm saying to all you guys out here, you're too busy trying to visualize a positive outcome when you're not a positive person. You're too busy trying to lie to yourself and say to yourself that I'm good enough to get this pussy when you know you're not even good enough for yourself. And then when you set yourself up on a high bar or set the bar high and you don't get what it is you want, then you're the one that's upset and you're the one that's mad and you're the one that's angry because most you guys are not soaking up the game. It doesn't make any sense how you guys are moving this way and how is it, guys, that you guys sit around and lie to yourselves and pretend that you're something? How is it? How is it that you guys sit around and play games? Why do y'all play with yourselves? And I don't mean play with yourselves that way. But why do you guys, why don't you, you want to know why you don't have the control? Gentlemen, I keep telling you, listen, I know I sound like a broken record. I want you to win. Listen to me. And I'm serious. I want you all to win. And gentlemen, we are less than three weeks, August is our annual day. August is our annual day. We're the only ones that recognize August. I have been trying everything I can to get y'all prepared for August. A new batch of women are coming in August. And these women are going to want to expand and express their sexuality. And you know why they fuck with the older guys? Because the older guys are the only motherfucking ones that know what they're doing and you don't. What I am saying is, you guys out there, it's not about who you are to the outside world, gentlemen. It's about who you are and what you accomplish for yourselves. And that's what y'all don't understand. Because most of you guys actually believe that you are below average. You don't believe that you deserve anything. You guys don't think that you deserve the life of a man. You guys feel like you don't deserve women. But here's the thing about a fucking man. We don't give a fuck about women like that to even think about what it is we deserve or not, because the only person we deserve is ourselves. And that's why I keep trying to tell you, I know this sounds crazy, but when you get this fucking attitude of a goddamn villain, and start realizing that you deserve you, then you begin to change your attitude. You can't change an attitude if you don't believe in self. You cannot change the attitude. You cannot do that. Because it's the attitude that a man has for himself. Listen to what I'm saying. What I'm saying is, listen, I didn't say be mean to women. I didn't say be a dick to women. I didn't say and damn sure don't be nice to them. I'm saying that you have got to learn how to do the one thing that people tell you all the time, but y'all bypass it, and that's love yourself. You guys don't love yourselves. You guys don't care about yourselves. You guys are too insecure to stand on a principle of being a bad motherfucker. But how are you? Thank you, boxing. But how are you a bad motherfucker? Because bad motherfuckers move totally different. Okay? The reason why we are attractive to women is because we don't live by, hold on a second, 310, how can I help you? Dude, stop calling me. Get the fuck off my phone. I'm going to hang up on you. Do not call me again. Do not call me again. I'm going to hang up. Do not call me again. I'm trying to do a show. Do not fucking call me. Get coaching. Anyway, I'm sorry. I apologize. Anyway, what I'm saying to you guys out here, you guys are not going with your own flow. You guys are not following your own rules. I am the only one who have told all you guys out here. I've told each and every one of you guys out here. I have told all you guys three things that you have to follow. I've told you three things you have to follow. The law of the land. If you kill someone, they'll get you in the first 48. Law of the street. Don't drive faster than you can. And if you drive fast, be a part of the 100 club like I am, and you won't get a ticket. And last thing, the law of your job. Just do your fucking job. That's all you have to do. But the way game works is that you create the world to your specifications. Most of you guys out here, you guys don't understand or you guys don't know your own worth. You guys are always being shamed and you guys are always being told that, you know what? You guys are always being told to be what you think she wants you to be. The 100 Club is a club that you can join because what I do is I learn game, and I'm a full-time member, and the 100 Club is giving donations to falling firefighters and falling police officers. And then what they'll do is they'll give you a sticker and you put that motherfucker on the back of your truck or your car. And I promise you, when a police pulls up on your ass and looks at you and or whatever he does, he's going to look at that sticker and he's going to pull the fuck off. He ain't even going to bother you. There are loopholes in the game. There are loopholes in the game. But anyway, I'm not going to get into that. But if y'all don't know more, but I'm saying, what I'm saying to y'all guys is this. You don't understand your worth. You don't understand how beautiful you are. See, the beautiful thing about a man is he doesn't find strength in a woman because a woman doesn't validate us. We find strength in ourselves. And the reason why we find strength in ourselves because we do the one things y'all don't do. Y'all are hard on yourselves. It is okay to forgive yourself. You see what I'm saying? It's okay to do that. But see, the thing that you guys don't do is that you guys are not honest with yourselves, okay? You're not. You're not. And the beautiful thing about game, okay? The beautiful thing about game is that you have to have and love and an admiration for yourself. Because if you don't have a love and an admiration for yourself, you're going to put up with a lot of bullshit. And I'm telling you, you've got to be king. You've got to be emperor. You have got to be able to guide, to be able to say no to a woman and tell her good fucking bye. I don't need you. And I know y'all guys don't see that shit. I don't need a fucking, I don't need them. You know who I need? That motherfucker in the mirror. If that makes me an asshole, then I'm a fucking asshole. I don't give a fuck. I don't care. But I care enough to be honest with you. One thing that y'all ain't fucking doing. You're not being honest with women. Your honesty is just about, I just want to fuck you and that's it. That's not how, that's not game. The honesty is saying that, you know what, I'm going to tell you straight the fuck up. Number one, you ain't getting this dick. You ain't, yeah, I'm not giving you dick. You want to know why? Because you haven't even proven to me that you're worth my fucking time. You're worth my attention. You're worth my respect. What the fuck are you going to do to show me? Because you're not the only woman after me. You got to know your qualities and you have got to be unafraid of expressing yourself and accept what comes along with it. Why would I, why am I trying to fuck you? You think I'm trying to fuck you? No, I'm a break you. You want to know I'm a break you? Because you ain't special to me. You're like every guys, it's not being me. Just being honest. You're like every other woman out there. Ain't nothing special about you. I don't need you, baby. You need me. I don't need you. And if you don't like that, take your ass on. I don't give a fuck. But see, y'all think that's being mean. Y'all think that's being rude. Y'all want to be nice and kumbaya and work things out versus this is who the fuck I am and move without hesitation. And don't give a fuck about the end result. Because you guys think being this way doesn't get you pussy. This is what gets you the pussy. And y'all don't even see it. Because all your little fucking weak-ass program says, I got to get her to like me. I got to get her to be interested in me. I got to say a bunch of shit to make her act like I'm interested in her. Why do that silly shit? Why waste your time? Why pretend? I'm not pretending. This is who I am. But what throws them off is that I'm saying your pussy ain't enough. I don't give a fuck about, gentlemen, please understand. You don't have to give a fuck about the pussy to get the pussy. You guys give too much of a fuck about the pussy, and then you start acting like the pussy. Whatever you give a fuck about, you will become. And if you give a fuck about the pussy, you will become a pussy for the pussy, which means you ain't gonna get any pussy either. You're not gonna get any pussy for all my dogs out there. I'm saying to you guys out there is that, listen, I'm saying is that when are you going to be adventurous? I told you, y'all have killed the child. I'm not saying acting childish, but where is you have no creativity. You have no imagination. You have no sense of adventurousness. You don't have that, guys. You don't. Because you're not even open to experiencing things for yourself because you're too eager or you're too fucking afraid. And I'm not saying jump off a cliff and go skydiving and shit. I'm saying where is the sense of adventure in doing something impulsive as in love myself, as in work on myself and be daring enough to stand on your motherfucking square? That's going to show her that you're different. That's what's going to show her that. That's where y'all fuck up. Women don't want to be in your orbit if you don't have passion. What is the passion? The passion is in me. I love me. I am passionate about me. I desire me. I love me. I want me. I'm focused on me. And if you're that way, that means she's saying, well, what the fuck is wrong with me? Why aren't you focused on me? So guess what? What do I, the woman, have to do to get you to stop the... Think of what do I always show you guys? Remember I showed you this, and my Android users, I'm going to show you this. Remember I showed you this? Watch this. Watch this. Let me show y'all something. Let me show y'all, my guys. Y'all see that right there? What are you shining this light on? Okay? What are you shining this light on? Because whatever you shine this light on is going to show how worthy you are. And that light should be shined on you. And when that light is shined on you, then she's going to ask, what do I have to do to get him off that light and put some of that light on me? That's what I'm saying to you motherfuckers. Shine the light on yourselves. Stop trying to get sex and learn how to be sexy. Stop trying to get the sex and learn how to be sexy. Make a woman melt when you talk to her. Make her melt when you touch her. Make her nervous when she's going to see you. But y'all don't understand that kind of the game because you guys don't even look at yourselves as opportunities. You have to learn how to be charming. Don't you charm yourself. Gentlemen, I laugh at myself all the time. Laugh at yourself all the time. I have a sense of humor, but I also have self-awareness of me. I don't take myself seriously, and I win. You guys have to have the perfect line. You have to have the perfect date. You've got to say the perfect things. A woman will say something to you, and you'll look at it, and you'll pander, and you're, oh, my God, okay. She said this. What do I say? Well, if I say that, she's going to do this and this. Oh, well, that's not right. Well, I got to say this. No, I got to say this. No, why the fuck do you do that? Why do y'all do that to yourselves? I'm saying to you guys out here, you've got to learn how to be the fucking villain. Gentlemen, a woman is not going to tell you to. I'm the only one to tell you this. Please understand these women going to fucking lie to you. They're going to do everything they can to throw you off the scent. They're going to do everything they can to show you, I want a guy to be sweet, to be kind, to be thoughtful, to be caring, and that's what I want. Motherfucker, you have been doing that shit, and where's it gotten you? Oh, you're sweet, but, oh, you're kind, but, well, I don't see you as, keep doing that stupid ass shit. Women don't want the good fucking guy. They want a dominant motherfucker that is intriguing, that is thrilling, that has no inhibition, excuse me, and also a motherfucking that is going to say, if you don't like it, there's the fucking door. I don't care. Y'all care too much. And because you care, you become caring and thoughtful and nice and kind and sweet and romantic and all these other soft ass things where we're saying that, you know what? No, fuck no. Listen. I am going to hurt your feelings. You're not going to like me. I'm going to piss you off. But you're also going to want to fuck me in that process. You guys, you want her to like you. I want you to like me. I don't want her to. Why the fuck? Guys, I ask you this question. Why would I want her to like me? What is her liking me going to get me? Oh, I forgot. I'm sweet. And I'm kind. And I'm thoughtful. Fuck you. I don't want to hear that shit. But see, that's what the game is about. See, here's the thing, dog, okay? The problem with you motherfuckers is you care about her feelings. And I'm telling you motherfuckers, fuck her feelings. Because she's using her fucking feelings to throw you off the mark. Well, I just want a guy that's sweet. You know, I just want a guy to whisk me off my feet and show me that I'm man, fuck you. I don't care about her opinion. I don't give a fuck about that shit. I'm telling you. I don't give a fuck. And what I am saying to this is I am trying to conquer. I am not going to manipulate you. Why the fuck would I do that? I'm not going to try to manipulate you. I'm not going to lie to you. I'm not going to beat around the bush. Why would I do that? This is who I am. But wait. Listen, guys. Listen. But I'm not even trying to fuck you right now. Why would I give the best part of me away to you? Wait, I don't think y'all understand this shit. I'm going to show you why they give us the pussy and why they don't give you shit. Because unlike you thirsty motherfuckers, you ain't getting this dick for free. Wait a second. Why would I give you something that a lot of women are beating my door down to get? I know that sounds crazy, guys. Okay, let's flip this shit. Why do you think these guys are beating down a door to get their pussy as if that pussy is something special? You guys made the pussy special. You motherfuckers made the pussy special. But in making the pussy special, what have you downgraded? What have you said that ain't? What have you taken special away from? The dick. You guys have not shown appreciation for the motherfucking dick. And I'm telling y'all right now, this is the pathway to get a man. This is the pathway getting a pussy. By letting her know that you have got to show me your worth. You've got to show me your worth, my attention, my time, my respect. And then if you're lucky enough, you get the dick. And I know y'all guys think that's crazy, because I know you're saying, wait a second, it doesn't make any sense. I mean, why would you think that way? Why not think our way and beg for the pussy and just give your dick away freely? And she ain't even working for that shit. She's not even working for it. Because you motherfuckers always feel that you're entitled to pussy. But no, it doesn't work that way. See, you guys don't understand motherfuckers who get pussy. See, motherfuckers who get pussy don't make it about the pussy. So it tells the woman that there's something about this guy. There's something about this guy that's different. I've always told you, dumb motherfuckers, before the internet, I've always told you, all you got to do is look at James Bond. It's simple. That's how simple it is. Here's the question. How is it that this motherfucker, all he does when he introduces, hello, my name is Bond, James Bond. But how is he always fucking the women? He's not saying, hello, my name is Bond, James Bond. Can I get the pussy right now? Hello, my name is Bond, James Bond. Can you come over my place right now so I can beg you for your pussy? But yet, how is he getting that pussy? Because women are watching how that motherfucker moves and says he is a very intense, passionate motherfucker. And if he's like that outside the bedroom, then he's going to blow my back out versus you thirsty motherfuckers. And I love this is one bad motherfucker right here. My motherfucking dog, the one straight out of the dojo, Taekwondo motherfucking doe. When you watch James Bond, you gotta see how he moves. I'm telling y'all, I can't make this up. Watch how he, gentlemen, I'm gonna explain to you why he gets the pussy. He's fucking, but he's so smooth, he's telling the woman, damn, this motherfucker is fucking. Why? Why? I'm going to show y'all why. Why is James Bond fucking and not trying to get the pussy? Because my dog, Ty, I'm even telling my dog, Ty. Because the number one thing about James Bond, he's the fucking master of his fucking emotions. He doesn't show intimidation. He doesn't show anything. He says that, you know what? He is demonstrating his power by controlling his fucking actions, his thoughts, his emotions, and his dick. I'm going to say it again. He's controlling his actions, his thoughts, his fucking feelings, and his dick. He ain't giving the dick away. I keep telling you guys. Y'all are just saying, take this cubic zirconian dick. It doesn't matter what James Bond, watch them all. They ain't giving away the dick for free. But what draws the woman in is like this motherfucker below me, my dog Taekwondo motherfucking Doe, is that he's a very intense motherfucker. We don't just look at women, motherfucker. We look through them. We are able to look at these women in a way where they shy off. Like, oh my God, what are you looking at? Baby, I'm looking at you. Get your eyes back over here and look at me. I'm looking at things in you and about you that you don't even motherfucking know. Because I'm creating this thing called sexual tension. Sexual tension that's so thick it can be cut with a motherfucking knife. What else is it about James Bond and a man? Is that we are a fucking challenge. The dick, she's got to go to Gander Mountain. She's got to get her equipment, gentlemen. And what she has got to motherfucking do is climb our mountain to get to the dick. She's got to work hard. We're not giving the dick for free. Shout out my dog, Ty. We're not doing that. We're putting her ass to work. We're putting her ass to work. Because what we're saying is, I'm not going to run behind you. I'm the fucking prize. What? Wait. How can we be the prize when the pussy's the prize? The pussy's the prize when you don't value your dick. But when you value your motherfucking dick and realize that she's got to work to get it, then your value goes up because you're saying, I am taking the power out of the pussy. But gentlemen, also, if you notice about James Bond, you never notice he's not playing with his cards facing the other way. There is something about a motherfucking man that is mysterious. They're trying to figure him out. They're saying, this is my program. My program is that, you know, the guys that I know are thirsty, desperate, and will do anything to get a sniff of this pussy. They want to take me out. They want to shine and give me things. But why isn't this motherfucker running behind me? Why is he telling me what to do? Why is he so quick to dismiss me? Why is he doing this? Because you know what? A man doesn't reveal everything at once. Thirsty motherfuckers say, all I want to do is fuck. You know what a man does? He says, you got to earn this motherfucking dick. I don't want to fuck you because we're already fucking right here. We're already fucking right here. And what I'm saying to you guys, and I'll answer that question in a second, what I'm saying to you guys is this. Y'all guys are always apologizing for who the fuck you are. You're always sorry for being a male. You're always apologizing for being a male. We don't teach you guys to take pussy or anything like that. Oh, fuck no. We move at our own pace. And we're not ashamed of what the fuck we are because it's what we are that draws them to want to fuck us. Where they miss us, think about us, need us, want to touch us, want to kiss us, want to fuck us. They want us. And y'all can't understand that because while we are taking control, they are losing control. Because if she doesn't have a program on you, all she's going to do is think about you. We control the situations. We take the lead and we never step foot in her fucking world. Even though she invites us in, we do not go into, gentlemen, her world. And that's what y'all don't understand. When all you guys want to do, if you all you do want to fuck, how does she feel safe around a thirsty motherfucker with no experience? That is what? Going to run behind her? Going to be insecure? Going to always be in her business and she can't even do anything? She gives you pussy. She's like, God damn, I should have never fucked him because now I can't get rid of him. Why is he always checking on my messages? And why is he always questioning who I'm talking about? And why is y'all, men don't move this fucking way. Men don't move this way. But this is why a lot of y'all guys mess up in the game. Because all I tell you guys, if you just take a moment to watch James Bond, and ask yourself the question, how in the fuck is that woman knocking on his goddamn door at one in the morning? Knocking on his door wanting to give up that motherfucking pussy. Because he's never going after the pussy. He's never running behind the pussy. He's never doing that. Because he makes the game about himself. Think about what I'm saying. What do you think he's creating? What do you think? How do you think he's moving? He moves in a way where she is attracted to him. She feels safe around him. She can, women, guys, I'm telling you, August right around the corner, we're going to be talking about this. She feels good with him because she never feels judged. I'm telling y'all, you need to watch that. Other than the explosions, the killing, the driving, and the fast cars. You see how smooth, y'all got to see how smooth he is with the women. When he gets next to the woman, man, he put number flavor in her fucking pussy's on fire. And all she's doing is trying to control herself by saying, oh my God, I got to control my fucking pussy right now because I want to fuck the shit out of this guy. Oh my God, I just wonder what it's going to be like when he's putting his lips on me. What is it like when he grabs my hand the first time? What is it like when he pulls me close to him? What is it like when he leans in and kisses me? What is it going to be like when he starts to unbutton and undress me? What is it going to be like when he's in my ear? What is it like when he's eating my pussy or kissing me or saying, do you see all these things? That's the benefits of being a man. They don't think about that shit with you guys. They're saying, man, okay, I know what this is going to be. I'm going to give him the pussy. He's going to get on it for a few moments. He's going to hop off and go to sleep. That's all I get. So I might as well get a dinner out of this shit or something out of this shit. What is it like the first time he puts his hand around my back, puts his hand on my thigh, puts his hand on my face, puts his lips on my side, puts his lips on my chest, my stomach, my thighs, what is it going to be like? What is it? The anticipation of that. Y'all hear what I'm saying? What is it going to be like the first time he slides it in? What is it going to be like when he pulls out? What is it going to be like after that? What is it going to be like the first time I'm in the shower with him? What is it going to be? Gentlemen, listen to all the what is it going to be like? She's thinking all this shit, guys. What is it going to be like versus... It's just another thirsty motherfucker trying to fuck me. That's what I'm saying to y'all guys. This is why game is so important to soak up, because y'all guys are missing the point in all this. Please watch a James Bond movie, gentlemen. Please watch it, because the only way you'll be able to understand Bond and understand what I'm talking about is you just got to ask the question, why is Bond fucking and he ain't trying to fuck? Why is he getting all the pussy? Why is Bond getting all the pussy and he ain't trying to fuck? So you say, so when rehearsing, should I be aiming for the right flow? No, you need coaching. You can't do it on your own. Steve, how does that look practically feel with a woman starting out with you, first dates, and soon as you smash bait? Wait, how does that look? What are you talking about? How does what look? I don't understand. What are you talking about? I need more. I don't understand what you mean. I don't understand what you mean by that. Yeah, oh, no. Hey, sucker free. Absolutely. Absolutely. You know, Billions is one of my things. I tell these guys all the time. Y'all got to see how motherfuckers move. Not because they're billionaires. It's the attitude behind the fucking money. It is this attitude to say, I'm the motherfucker. I'm the guy. And y'all, most of y'all guys never believe in yourselves to be the guy. Where is your intensity at? And I'm not talking about the intensity with her. Where is your intensity? Where is it at? What part of you shows that you're the fucking guy? Are you congruent in who you are? See, here's the thing that y'all are all over the place. Because this is what y'all excuse are. Women are different. Times are different. Things are different. So, who gives a fuck? Time is different. Every day is different. Days turn into nights. Winter, rain, snow. Those are all different. But a man is always the motherfucking same. Text message here. You have to give me more than this. Wait. You're going to have to give me more than this before you can see me in a black outfit. I can't make it easy for you. Where would the fun be in that? Well, then goodbye. Because I need a fucking woman that's going to follow my instructions. And if you cannot follow my instructions or my program, then you're wasting my fucking time. Goodbye. And when you change your mind, come back to me. Put a candle in the window, motherfucker. What I would see, this is why I would tell you guys, stop acting like you're a man and be a man. And you want to know what this is, gentlemen, right here? This is a motherfucker that cherry-picked game, said some shit, and now the woman is challenging him. And if you ain't standing on what the fuck you say, then you full of fucking shit. Because the fun in it is when you follow instructions, then there's going to be rewards that come with that. You unlock those things. But nobody said making things easy, because getting this dick is not an easy thing. Y'all hear what I'm saying? That's what I'm saying, you big dog. Stop trying to play man and be a man. Question, being fully immersed in yourself? No. Fuck no. Absolutely not. Absolutely not. Absolutely not. Because yourself sucks right now. So why would you be immersed with a fucking loser? And let me show you what a loser is, King Mike. Let me show you why you're a bitch. And I say this with love, because this is what losers do. Why do you care what she comes back with, bitch? This is why you are a weak motherfucker. This is why you're feminine. See, this is why the red pill in the manosphere is fucking you bitch ass motherfuckers up. Why do you give a fuck what she comes back with when you're not trying to have a relationship with her, you dumb fuck? So what if she comes back with four kids? Who cares? Are you trying to have a relationship? See, let me tell you why King Mike is a bitch. Because see, King Mike knows he ain't shit. King Mike knows he can't fuck. King Mike knows he ain't got no game. So what King Mike has been walked over, ran over, and treated like a bitch. And then when a bitch realizes she ain't shit, she comes back to his weak motherfucker ass, and he all mad in his fucking pussy ass feelings. Don't come in here with that manosphere shit, bitch. Fuck out of here. Fuck out of here with that silly shit. Who said that you have got to play with the kids? Who said that you got to be in a relationship with the bitch? So that you already can see that you a bitch motherfucker. Unless you see, say, this motherfucker want a relationship. See, you already showing why you're weak, dumb fuck. Because nobody said you have to be in a relationship. Nobody said, JB, dumb fuck, that you got to give your money up, stupid ass. This is why y'all are suckers. Because if you had game, you can still fuck her and let her go back home to her goddamn kids. But see, you motherfuckers don't understand women that way. Because some women just want some dick. They don't want you to be a fucking father to their kids. Why would a woman, JB and fucking King, want to put their kids around a weird, creepy, thirsty, needy, soft motherfucker? Some women don't even want you around their fucking kids. So what makes you think that they want you around their kids, dumb fuck? Mud, I got you. What's your question? Why do some guys say they like to chase as men, to chase as women who they like, core, and then they stop being direct as a... Mud, call in. I understand what you're saying. Mud, call in, please. Mud, call in. I understand what you're saying, baby. Call in. Just call in, please. Call in real quick, Mud. Call in, okay? Call in, Mud. If you can. Just call in. I don't understand what you're saying. Call in. Call in. What I'm saying to you guys out here, now I'm not going to read it slow. You call in, girl. Call the fuck in and explain yourself. What I'm saying to y'all guys is this. All you guys listening. When you have game, okay? When you have game, okay? When you have game. The game is not about the woman. So King Mike, I'm going to ask you, please shut the fuck up if you want to be in here. We don't want to hear that bitch ass shit. We don't want to hear that bitch shit because you're not going to bring no poisonous red pill rhetoric in a man's space. Who gives a fuck how many kids she has? Who gives a fuck what her situation is? And she can't come back for something you don't give her, dumb fuck. This is why y'all weak. Do y'all see why y'all lose? Because you're listening to weak motherfuckers and y'all have no self-awareness. You have no confidence. A man does not give a fuck about her situation because who says that I'm going to be a part of her situation? It's funny how you thirsty, weak motherfuckers see women all day, every day that you want to fuck. Do you care about their situation? Do you, less, I'm asking all you, JB and that dumbass King, because y'all the dumb fuckers saying this stupid shit. Do you actually give a fuck about her situation? When you see someone you want to fuck, you ain't even thinking about her situation, you dumb fucks. It's funny how you think about their situation when they turn your ass down or they say they're not interested. Then all of a sudden, they're modern women. Then all of a sudden, they have a high lay count. Then all of a sudden, oh, she must have a bunch of kids or a bunch of baby daddies. You don't think about that weak ass shit because your punk asses are saying, oh, she's so beautiful. What do I say to get her? You don't think about her situation when you're in the gym and you see her little thick ass walking by. You don't think about her situation when she's at a bar or a club. You don't think about her situation. It's only when she turns your weak ass down is you're thinking about her situation. Don't come with that shit. Stop. Stop that shit. Y'all got to be more manly. What does a woman need to prove to us to qualify to get our dick? Sort of confused. What are you talking about? I'm not making her wait to do anything. I'm not making her wait to do anything. It's just that I love my dick too much. I'm a very skilled lover. So why would I give me away for free? Unlike you weak motherfuckers who are not skilled, who are not experienced. But I want y'all to understand something. Wait, let me take this out. Hey, let me take this out of my ear. All right. You know the difference between this thing, this diamond in my ear, and cubic zirconium? Because this diamond has more worth, even though it's glass. This diamond has more worth on it because it's been held from the marketplace. Cubic zirconium, you could go to Walmart and get a handful of these fake-ass earrings and shit that have no value to it. You motherfuckers don't have value. You guys don't have any value. Bring in 850. 850, sir, how can I help you, sir? What's your question, brother? What's up? 850, what's going on, brother? What's up?
Steve, I was agreeing with you.
Agreeing what?
This is JB.
Agreeing with what? No, you over there, butt rubbing that bitch ass King over there.
No, I'm saying because the way that he carries himself, that they're going to come back for his money. They're not coming back because he has anything of value.
They're not going to come back for his money because he has nothing to offer them. They don't want him. Okay, listen to me, JB. Do you know, every woman, if they choose, can have over 100 banks right now? 100 guys, if they choose to take their money, they can get it. Even though they know they can get their money, their rent, their phone bill paid, dinners, expensive, whatever they want, why don't they take the money?
They don't want to deal with the guy.
Because exactly. So it doesn't matter about the money. Because if you're a loser, it doesn't mean they don't. Listen, they're saying this. You're so bad of a loser, I don't even want your money. No one I can get your money. You're so creepy and weird that I know I can have my bills, my rent, my phone, and a lavish lifestyle that I want. But fuck that. Because look what it comes with, a loser. So it doesn't matter. That's why I'm correcting you. They don't want your money because they know what is attached to the money. And what they're saying is this, fuck the money. I'd rather not have anything at all, because knowing that loser's attached to that shit, I don't even want his fucking money. That's how fucked up these guys are. I don't want his money. You see what I'm saying, sir?
Yeah, so
stop all this. They come back for your money, because that's manosphere talk. Because women have the option to have money right now, and they're not even fucking with these guys, knowing they can have all the expensive purses, shoes, clothes, rent paid, bills paid, brand new shit. But they're saying that motherfucker is so weird and creepy. Fuck that. I don't want his money. So stop making those false accusations, because that's not true. Women don't come back for your money, because if you're fucked up, they don't want your money. And they can have, listen how crazy it is. They can have their money, but they don't want the money. So there's got to be something with that motherfucker that's so fucked up. They're saying fuck no to the money. You see what I'm saying?
Yeah, I see what you mean.
All right, respect to you. I'm going to throw you back in. Okay, brother? Thank you.
All right,
respect. Yes, thank you for the call. Thank you. All right, let's see here. What is he saying here? He said the game runs a lot of women away. Would that be wrong for... No, wait a second. Wait. The game doesn't run women away. First off, how can you say the game does anything when you're not in the game? And with King Mike, I'm going to give you a minute to call in. If you don't, I'm going to block you. You got 1 minute starting. I'm going to give you 1 minute to call in right now. You got 1 minute to call in. You don't call in, I'm going to block you. Don't touch him. I got him. If you want to call in, you call in. You have one minute. You have one fucking minute to call in, or you're being blocked. So I'm going to give you a chance to call in. Hey, y'all can't say I didn't give him a chance. He don't do this. You might as well block me now before I get you. You've got 40 seconds. Anyway, Mr. Neil, who said you're in the game? Eric code 954. How can I help you, sir? 954. How can I help you, sir?
Hey, Steve, what's up? Quick question. If I have a... a situation like with the pathway, do I just email you or?
Yes, you do that on the back end. Yes, sir.
All right.
Thank you, sir. Okay, thank you. Okay. So King has 10 more seconds. King doesn't call him. We're going to let him go. Because I'm going to show you what the game is about right now. You know what the game is about? The game is about you being a fucking man and calling in when you had the opportunity. Bye. See you. See that? You want to know what the game is about? I just showed him. Now you, Jared, stop. Jared. Why are you lying and act like you have game? You have no motherfucking game. So why the fuck are you using words that you ain't even a part of? Jared, I want you to call in and explain yourself. Because I cannot stand a guy who doesn't have game to sit here and act like he has game. Jared, you have 1 minute to call in starting now. You got a minute to call in, Jared, because I want to see what the fuck you're talking about with game, because I cannot stand people who are not gamed up using the word game. Because if you had game, sir, because I'm about to let you go, because you almost got 30 minutes to call in. I'm going to let you go. And I'm going to explain it to you before I let you go. So, Jared, you better call in so I can educate your fucking ass, because you're lying right now. And gentlemen, you know I don't like show-offs. You know I love your questions, guys, and I appreciate your questions. I just don't like when guys call into they come in and ask a question to make you guys look bad, knowing they don't have game. That's why I protect you guys. I don't want anybody calling it, asking a question, and then can't back it up. So, okay, well, Jared, before I let you go, before I block you, I'm going to show you why you don't have game. Why do you give a fuck? Why do you give a fuck what women do? But let me let you go and so I explain to those students to help them out. See, my dog's out there. This is why I let his ass go. See, gentlemen, when you have game, the game is not about women. You don't give a fuck if they come or go. Why do you care? What do you mean? What? So wait, let me guess. So I have to lighten who I am up for a fucking woman? Are you serious? So what he's saying, guys, is that you're supposed to move your crossbar for her. You're supposed to give her a chance and an opportunity. Fuck that. Don't do that. Dog, call in if you have that question. I always tell your ass that goddamn same thing, and you keep asking me the same question. Call in for that. Anyway, what I'm saying to y'all guys is this. When you have game, you are one thought, one mind, one way. And if that person cannot understand or handle what you are, then you will dismiss them. You don't, gentlemen, I'm trying to tell y'all don't change. Don't you fucking change for a woman. The moment you move your goalpost for a woman, she's going to stop respecting you. And if he had game, he would realize that you want these fucking women to go and find these suckers so they can come the fuck back. But see, he didn't have game, and I had to let him go, guys, because I don't like guys making y'all feel bad. It's not fair for you guys, because you know what, guys? I appreciate you guys. I do. And I don't like guys coming in here making it look like they have something that they don't to make you look small. We don't do that here. I don't want nobody to belittle you because I appreciate you guys. But motherfuckers who don't have game can't come in this motherfucker talking like they have game. Especially when they have insecurities, gentlemen. When they have low self-esteem. Listen to what I'm saying. A lot of you guys just don't believe in yourselves. And I'm not knocking you because you don't believe in yourself. I'm trying to show you how to love and honor yourself as a man so you can win. You can't win this way. You will never win this way. You will never have a woman in your orbit when you are not believing in yourself. You'll never do that. This is why most of you guys fail, because you don't have a standard or a program in how you operate. And your standard and program is based on some pussy. So that means if it's a red woman, a white woman, or a black woman, you are going to act different with every woman because you don't have a standard. Like I was saying earlier. Times change, weather change, women change, all these things change. But the man is the common denominator that never changes. If you don't like what the fuck I am, there's the door. I never asked you to stay. I never asked you to hang around. You have free will. Guys, I'm telling you, free will is everything, guys. Give her the option to fucking stay or go, but let her make the choice, because I'm not begging you to do anything. I'm not. What the fuck would I beg you for? I'm too busy begging myself. I'm too busy begging my scribe to write things for me. I'm too busy begging my marketing team to market me better. I'm too busy begging my drug lag to come up with the fentanyl of me or the Percocets of me. I am too busy begging. My motherfucking, all of me, my mental gym, I'm sorry, to keep building me. The program you get, send me an email at themanmindset@gmail.com and I'll send you the pathway to start. It's right there. You see right there, it's right there. See that right there? Your pathway, themanmindset@gmail.com. Error code 832. How can I help you, sir? What's going on? 832, how can I help you?
Yeah, you know, like having game, you know, sometimes the women be afraid and things like that.
What are you talking about? Afraid of what?
You know, the guy, they feel like, oh, he's so full of himself. He probably do every girl like this. Like, you ain't finna run no game on me. You ain't finna get this pussy from me like the other girls get
it to said, you. But who said it? Who, then you're not talking about game. What are you talking about? Who said the game is about pussy?
I'm talking about the women. Women can feel that shit. Guys can feel the game too.
Wait. Women can feel what? You thirsty for some pussy?
No, they can feel that energy of you being that type of dude that have your way when it comes to women. And guys can also feel that you that nigga. That's why they get jealous and shit too.
What is your question?
My question is, should you lighten the game up sometimes to accommodate people in their weak areas?
Then you ain't got no game if you're a cop. Dog, you ain't got no game, dog. Why the fuck are you accommodating a fucking woman? What bitch ass guy, I'm gonna say this with love, what soft motherfucking guy is gonna accommodate a woman? Are you serious?
You know, sometimes you know women sometimes can be a little insecure, so you gotta like, hey baby, it's okay. You know, I know you don't always get around niggas.
She's gonna feel secure in me because I have game. But why would I change myself for a fucking piece of pussy? Tell me.
Why would I or why would you?
No, I'm saying, sir, listen to what you're saying, because you don't have any game. You're saying that I need to change who the fuck I am for some pussy? For a woman?
For some scared pussy. You know, the woman, she digging you, but she feel a little intimidated. So sometimes you got to, like, talk to her a little bit, you know?
Sir, talk to her for what?
Because she's a little intimidated. Hold on. Excuse me. You know, sometimes when you're dealing with a woman, she can be a little intimidated. And sometimes you gotta, like,
I'm going to let you go. I don't know who he's talking to. I'm gonna move on. Are y'all serious here? Y'all actually want to lighten yourselves up over a woman? Are you guys, let me get this straight. This is who I am. But I never said I'm trying to fuck you. I never said that I'm trying to get your pussy. I'm trying to conquer you. Man, what is it that you want? Because you ain't going to sit here and talk to no motherfucker while we on live, dog. Are you done talking to another dude?
That was a woman, brother.
I don't give a fuck if you're a woman. I don't give a fuck what she say. Why do you care what the bitch say?
I was trying to show you the proof of, like, women, sometimes you got to switch your game up a little bit. Just
dog,
a little
okay,
bit.
Dog, okay, so show me when a lion switches itself up to be a duck.
Sometimes.
Show me when a lion is a duck.
Sometimes a lion loses his life because he's always running out. Sometimes you got to have a little strategy and catch her a little later. You don't always got to be the super aggressive. Sometimes you can be a little finesse.
Sir, catch her later for what?
I'm saying, when you talk about a predator and a prey, sometimes you can be aggressive and sometimes you can be finesse.
Wait a second. Wait, sir. What's the end game? For what?
Well, you talking about the lion or you talking about the guys or the women? Which one are you talking about?
Why am I lightening myself up? For what? What am I lightening myself up?
Because at the end of the day, the woman wants you. The woman wants you, but you got to make her feel like, hey, it's okay. I know you always see guys looking this good.
Do I want a woman to want me? Do I want a woman to want me? Yes or no? Do I teach guys to get women to want them?
No, it's so I don't know what you're teaching
necessarily. So fuck her feelings and fuck what she want. Why the fuck do I care what she want? Tell me. Why do I care?
But you want her though, right?
You're putting your bid in, right? Wait. Who said I wanted her? Maybe I'm giving her, sir. Unlike you, I'm teaching these men. I'm giving her opportunity to suck my dick. What the fuck are you talking about? Me want her? Why do I need her when I can get women easily? What is it in for me? What do I get out of it? What do I get out of it running behind her fucking ass? Tell me. What do I get out of it? Tell me.
You can get cooperation. You can get sex. You can get a lot of different things. I'm not saying, brother.
You're in the wrong place. That's some bitch ass shit you saying right there. That's some bitch ass shit.
So you don't chase women, right?
What, chasing for what? For what?
And you also don't want women, right?
Wait a second. Chasing for what? One thing at a time. Chasing for what?
Okay. Let's delete chase, because I don't even like that word chase. You don't want women, right?
I am showing them why they need me. I'm not a want. I'm a need, brother. So I don't want for shit, and I don't give a fuck about their wants. So what are you talking about?
So you put on a performance, you're showing them why they should want you. Are you selling yourself, right?
I am the... Wait. What do you mean put on a performance? What you see is what you get. Why am I going to play a role in shit? Why do I have to run behind women? Wait. You want pussy. Yeah. You want pussy. That's all you want, right? Right?
Not at all.
So then what are you moving your goalposts for then? What is your main reason to lighten your weak ass up? For what?
The main reason why I would lighten the game up with a woman, because at the end of the day, she need to understand, hey, I know you probably overwhelmed. You ain't never seen a nigga looking as good like this, but it's cool.
What is your looks? Cool. Wait. Sir, stop. Yeah. Now you're talking about your looks. What does your looks got to do with your mindset, motherfucker?
My mindset is good. She see what she sees, and she already feels a certain type of way. Oh, my God.
Dog, are you fucking playing, dog? Are you serious?
I'm dead serious. When you're looking good and smelling good, and you got that walk and you got that mindset like you're talking about,
no.
Some guys get jealous and some women get intimidated, but you got to go over there, dog, and you know, hey.
Dog, stop. Come on. How old are you, dog? How old are you? You got what?
18? I'm 32.
You're 18.
I'm 32.
No, no, you're 18.
No, women. No. I'm 32.
You're not 32. All right, wait. Hey, Mr. Badass, go back over to that bitch you was talking to and pull her. Mr. I look good. Because if you look that good, why don't you go live on the air right now over to her and just stand over and say, because I look good, you going to go get on his dick. Go ahead, Mr. Good Looking. Go ahead.
You want me to go back to the girl I was talking to?
Yeah, go ahead and pull her, Mr. Good Looking. Let's hear it. Let's go.
Okay, I'm going to knock on her door real quick because I was on the third floor. I'm on the first floor. Let me go back upstairs real quick. Let me go back upstairs. Give me one second. I ain't gonna play no games. I'm gonna knock on the door now. If she says some stupid shit,
No. It's not stupid shit. Because remember, you look good. So she should just be like, "Oh my God, you look so good. Take my pussy, right? Because you look good." No, you
I said. Say, I said you're looking good, you, and smelling good.
You look good, smell good. So hey, so she should be dead on your ass. So go ahead and knock on that door. Let's hear what the fuck you gonna say.
All right. Now, if she got a boyfriend, I got to smooth it out. I got to smooth it out with my mouthpiece. But watch this. Watch this.
All right, let's see.
Watch this. Let's see what she say. Now, I don't even want her, but I'm going to talk to her.
No, stop. No. Let's see it. Don't try to move. No, let's go see Mr. Good Looking and go do your thing, man.
All right, let me see. Let me see. I think it was this one right here. You got one?
Oh,
you single?
No, I'm married.
You married with your ring? What are you doing? Okay, cool. I was checking out. No? All right, I'll be cool then.
Yeah.
All right. The bitch was mad.
What did she just say?
The lady is married.
She's what?
The dude was actually in the house.
You couldn't tell that look.
But anywho, I knocked on the door and I hollered real quick. I don't know if she's single or not. Say she married or whatever.
Okay.
And the dude was inside the house too. No. But I'm just saying, sometimes when you're dealing with women, don't you feel like you got to lighten the game up a little bit by, you know,
what is lighting?
I know you're looking and shit, but it's cool, baby. Cool.
Who talks like that, dog? Who talks
everybody
that way?
Got different game.
Okay, sir. Why? Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and. I don't understand what you're doing. I don't. This is weird to me. All right. So, you have a good day, sir. That doesn't make dude never like. Don't ever, gentlemen, lighten up. Who the fuck you are over a fucking woman? That doesn't make any sense. What the fuck? Why would you be so intimidated by a woman that you gotta lighten up your stance? Fuck her. I don't give a hey. Listen, I'm not saying that to be mean to women. That's not being mean to women. She's just not special to me until she proves that she's special. And if she's not, move the fuck on. I don't care. You guys have got to show the attractiveness by how you fucking move, gentlemen. We all are going to hit a wall. Okay, we are. So your looks are going to deteriorate a little bit. Your body's going to wither a little bit. That's called dying. But you've got to live with your mouthpiece, man. Y'all can't be on no suck ass shit. We're going to do 15 more minutes, though. 15 more. Y'all got questions and anything like that. But I'm just saying for you guys out here, don't lighten up who the fuck you are for a woman. Never stay. Okay, that's like your job saying, hey, how you doing, sir? We're going to lighten the mood up and we're going to take, we're going to add $2 to your pay today. And then tomorrow we're going to unlighten up and we're going to take $3 back from you. Motherfuckers don't work that way, man. Come on, guys. Y'all got to listen. Y'all got to be careful about who y'all run behind. Y'all be careful about who y'all follow. Because motherfuckers with game will never tell you to lighten up. Never move and lighten up for anybody. Stand on who you are. Move on who you are. Move the way you are, guys. Guys, listen. I promise you. I'm not saying that you're going to be an asshole. That's not what I'm saying. You're going to be perceived as an asshole. I don't want you to be stopped being nice to these fucking women. And I don't mean nice. I don't mean like, I'm not saying hit a woman, slap a woman, or cuss a woman out, or disrespect her. Stand on who you are and just stand on that. And be willing to lose the woman over that. And not lighten up who you are for her. Because as soon as she realizes your pussy is tight, as soon as she realizes you got a tight pussy, she's going to fucking run all over your ass. Stop doing this, man. You guys have got to have a love for yourselves, gentlemen. A love for yourselves. The motherfuckers that get pussy don't make it about pussy. Because there are things women will do for you. They will cook for you. I know that sounds crazy. Your birthday is coming around, they'll buy you a birthday present. You see what I'm saying? When you're a man, I promise you, when sucker me season comes, she'll cook Thanksgiving for you. She'll buy you Christmas presents. And then in February, she'll be taking your fucking ass out for Valentine's Day or cooking for you and giving you a gift because she's saying, baby, I love you. I love you. I want to be with you. I'm glad I'm with you. I'm not saying be mean to women. But y'all have got to stop using your fucking feminine ass feelings, man. Stop doing that, gentlemen. That's not attractive to a woman. It's not. The thing that's going to show how attractive you are, gentlemen, is how you move. Okay? That's what attractive is. That you don't change. You don't bend over backwards. You don't kiss her ass. You have got to know what you want. And I'm going to, it's a trick one, guys, because if all you want is pussy, you lose. But the motherfuckers that get pussy are the ones that want themselves. I want to get to know me better. I want to get to understand me better. I want to evolve. Those are the ones you should be wanting. But as soon as you say, I want some pussy, then you already lost. Because you don't even know what you want for your fucking self. A woman does not want a man who cannot make a decision for his fucking self. A woman wants a man who wants himself and is in pursuit of himself because he is drinking from the knowledge of himself. Women don't want soft. Women don't want guys that's going to say, well, I want what you want. Listen, The thing about a man, gentlemen, is that a man is always going to take what he has himself and make the most of it. This is why it doesn't matter if you're fat, short, tall, and all that other shit that they brown beat you on. Take what you have. I don't care if you don't have any money. You make the most of it. If you do have money, don't make it about the money. Make it about the man. Listen to what we're trying to say to you. Life is not perfect, but a man will make sure that it is close as fucking possible because he is perfect to himself. And that's what draws the pussy in. Not you, mother. Oh, well, she's got to. I'm not a man, so she's got to validate me. Women get turned down by men who have the ability to make the best out of a situation. Every decision that he makes is not supposed to impress the woman. He is making an impression, motherfucker. I'm not trying to why would I want to impress a woman? Why not make an impression that lasts longer? Think about that, gentlemen. When women want to fuck you, they'll realize this man could be a great husband, a great father, a great man, because he's a great motherfucking leader. Most of you guys don't understand. They can smell procrastination a long way. Let me see. Okay, it was. Listen, dumbass, and I say this with love, because you got to be fucking kidding me. Gentlemen, you want to know why this is bad? Because you're dressing for the bitch. So that means you're tricking your money off for a bitch. You're not dressing for you. You're dressing for the woman. So that means you're tricking your money. So you're spending your money to dress a certain way to impress a woman. And as soon as you open your bitch mouth, sir, as soon as you open your weak ass mouth, sir, you're going to tell the woman while you're in your listen, guys, while he's in his fancy little outfit, while you're in your little fancy outfit, you're telling a woman that you have the inability to handle failure. You don't have initiative. You procrastinate. You motherfucker, you don't know how to express or explain yourself. You don't know how to handle criticism. You have a fixed mindset. You have no ability to do anything. So go ahead and wear your Armani suits and all that other shit. Go ahead. Hey, go to the store. Get suited and booted. Spend all your money. Trick your money because you want to look good for the woman. And as soon as you open your weak motherfucking mouth, she's going to realize that you are a failure who limits itself, who does not grow, who has no mouthpiece or anything like that. So go ahead. Dress fine. Hey, guys, dress fine. Please. Go in and dress fine. Go ahead and wear all that trick him. Hey, gentlemen, this is why he's losing, because he's equating his clothes to pussy. Go ahead and dress fine for the bitch and see, she still ain't gonna want to fuck with you. Go ahead, be suited and booted. Because as soon as you open your fucking mouth, she gonna know you a weak bitch. So go ahead and dress up. Go ahead, play dress up. Go ahead, play dress up. Because it's a damn shame that everything you want to do is for a woman, and that's a goddamn shame. I don't have to dress up, and I get tons of but I don't. Hey, listen, I got a closet full of nice clothes. I don't want to fucking. Well, I don't like wearing and dressing that shit up because I don't stand on my fucking clothes. Because why wear all that stuff when they want to take the clothes off anyway? I'm sorry. Hey, go ahead and dress up. Go ahead and dress up and stay in your clothes while you're taking her to dinner. Go ahead and dress up and stay in your clothes while you're fixing shit. Go ahead and dress up and let her cry on your fucking shoulder because she's talking about an asshole like me. But me, I want to have as least clothes as possible because she wants to take that shit off. She wants to take that shit off. So go ahead and dress up and be that guy to go ahead and pay her rent and all that other stuff while you looking good. Boy, look good. And now you're right, say, DG, that's a damn shame. Dressing for fucking women. What a fucking loser. And I say that with love. And I'm not even trying to be mean. I'm saying that with love. I am saying that with love. I'm saying to you guys real quick to you know, I got y'all. It's not wow. It's what it is. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Did I hurt your feelings? Oh, wait, I'm sorry.
Well, please forgive me. I didn't mean to say that. Please, sir. Oh, wait.
Hold on. I'm sorry. Wait a second. I think I hurt his little pussy. I'm sorry. Wait a second. Please forgive me. Wait, let me apologize. Where's the song at? Wait. Let me apologize to you. I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Please forgive me. Please forgive me. Let's play the music.
I'm so sorry. Please forgive me. I understand that your clothes make you a man. You're so special. And that nice Armani suit. Look at you. Suited and booted. Wow. I wish I could be like you, and I'm so sorry that you're going to be the bitch that's going to do all the things. And I want to say I'm sorry. Because I was wrong about you. I didn't mean to hurt your feelings. And if I said something to hurt your feelings, please understand. I didn't mean it. Because you'll be the one packing her shit up. Putting everything together. Oh, what a good guy. Look how nice he's dressed. While you're putting her stuff together. It's such a... I just want to say thank you. I also want to say thank you for being that guy. To listen to her. To understand her while you're wearing your nice suits and everything. You're such a great guy. I'm so jealous. Please forgive me. I didn't mean to upset you. And while you're wearing your clothes and you're on the corner of he's a loser in the friend zone. I just want to say, dress the part. Wow. You're so dapper. I wish I could dress like you. And then when you open your mouth and say, what do you do for a living? When was your last boyfriend? I like to cry because you know what? I understand you and I had my period the other day. Maybe we can have our periods together. So I just want to say to you that it's okay. And I appreciate you. Yes, please wear nice clothes. Have the nice shoes. Man, you're just such a winner. And always remember, guys, those days when you cramp, you have some jealous that you can't talk to a woman. When he has routines and their ability.
What do you want, man? Telling my vibe. Yes, sir. What's up? What can I help you with, sir?
Yeah, my service was bad, but all I was trying to say is sometimes you got to adjust the game. That's all.
Adjust the game. The game ain't about the bitch. So what are you adjusting?
Like when I'm talking to an officer, talking to a woman, I got to adjust a little bit of who I am at times.
Why? Why do you have to adjust who you are? What's the difference in what you're saying to an officer than somebody else? What are you saying? Why are you trying to be somebody else?
you know, when I'm talking to a cop being on that rah-rah shit, I'm also a black male. So
man,
being on that rah-rah crazy dumb
up,
shit.
Man. Please, listen, dog, you need some therapy. You need some therapy. Because I hate people. You know why I hate people like you? Because instead of honoring cops for saving your punk ass, you want to sit there and say, oh, I'm a black man. I'm a black man. Man, fuck you. How about that?
No, I don't hear this,
all this rah-rah shit. Why don't you get in your kumbaya shit? I can't stand people like you. I cannot stand people like you. You dog, please. Why are you bothering me with this bitch ass shit? Why are you giving me this victim as a black man? Go ahead. Finish the as I'm a black man. Tell me the go ahead and cry. I'm a black man, what? Go ahead.
No, I was telling you, I never tell a cop I'm a black man because of course they see my ethnicity. I'm telling you. So I'm just at the end of the day, being black, you know, being black and living in this society, being on that rah-rah, being on that extra overly masculine shit, that shit can get you in smoke sometimes. So you gotta play it cool. You gotta adjust to the game.
What are you talking about? Okay, dog, are you serious? Okay, dog.
So I adjust my game with women. I adjust my game at the car lot. I adjust my game with the cops. I'm not one way with everybody. I'm always gonna be me, but I adjust my game.
Why are you calling me, dog?
I'm talking football player in the game. I don't know if you still get women, but I know
I just started this yesterday. I don't know anything about women. So I don't think you should call me anymore. I don't know anything. Don't waste your time with me. I can't get women. I just started this shit yesterday. I don't know anything about the game, okay?
No, because I got a rotation in the game. That's all, man.
Get the fuck out of here and get the fuck off my phone with that bitch ass shit. I'm sorry, guys. Let me continue. I apologize. I'm sorry. Wait, did I hurt old guy's feelings? I hope he didn't leave. I'm sorry. I had to stop talking to one bitch to talk to another bitch. See how that shit go? And then y'all wonder why women don't want to fuck with y'all. Then y'all see why women don't want to fuck with y'all. Y'all motherfuckers are so goddamn soft.
I gotta be this way with officer friendly and all that. Man, come on, let me tell you something, man. Listen,
y'all gotta stop growing the fuck up. Y'all are getting a new batch of zebras, deer, antelope are coming into the Serengeti in August, and y'all don't even have y'all shit together. What are you still on that dog? Wait. Brother, look, buddy, sit your ass on the side, dog, please, please, please. Shout out to the 141 likes. Thank you guys. I have nothing but love for you guys. I appreciate y'all guys. But listen, here's the thing, guys. I am not saying be mean to women, but there has to come a time in your attitude where y'all have got to say, stop saying fuck women. Stop worrying about what they want. Because a woman, I'm telling you guys this right now, a woman is never going to give you the secret to get in her pussy. I don't know why y'all guys think they will do that. They will never tell you or put that on Front Street. This is what you've got to do, these five things, and I will open up my legs for you. Do you think women are going to do that shit? Guys, please. Come on, guys. Do y'all think that? Do you guys actually think that these women are going to give you five things to get to her pussy? Do you think, okay, be nice, caring, thoughtful, understanding, and respectful? Be all that shit and her say, well, you know what? I just want to let you know you're so sweet. And you know, I can never see you as a fucking man. I'm telling you guys, gentlemen, please stop believing the bullshit. He's got to have a nice car. He's got to make this kind of money. He's got to do this. He's got no guys. Let them find the suckers. I hate to use the word slavery, but let them have their plantation of suckers. Over there, let's look at her plantation. Can we look at her plantation of suckers? Over there, right over there in that barn over there is the plantation of motherfuckers that's going to put up her Christmas lights, her Halloween lights, and fix shit. Over in that plantation over there is going to be that sucker that's going to go ahead and buy her telephones and anything she wants and pay her fucking bills. on that side of the plantation, those motherfuckers are waiting to go ahead and buy her dinners and shit. I'm trying to get you motherfuckers off that plantation. Learn how to read and write. Get off the fucking plantation. Stop work. Y'all guys make pussy God. Y'all like,
well, I got the powerful pussy. Yeah, my pussy. Worship me. I got the power. Yeah, you want this pussy. Worship my pussy.
I'm telling you motherfuckers right now. Become an atheist in the game. Stop worshiping the pussy. Let them worship your dick. What if I'm told it turns her on? Hey, listen, right? No, you're right. No, hey, buddy, you're right. Hey, you're right. Because apparently you listen to what a fucking woman says. So, hey, no. Do it, buddy. Do it. Be well dressed. And she's going to say, this motherfucker can't fuck. He can't eat my pussy. And this is you in bed.
Excuse me. Let me fix my tie, baby. This tie is a special tie. Baby, I got this tie in Italy. Baby, you see these cufflinks right here, girl? Oh, man, these are specially made, baby. Yeah, you see this shirt? Yeah, I got custom made. I'm suited and booted, but can I ask you a question? Well, I was wondering if it's okay if, can I kiss you right now? Really? I kiss you? I kissed a girl. Oh my God, I kissed her. It really worked. I kissed a girl. Oh my God, I kissed a girl. Well, I don't want to mess up my suit and everything. Oh no. I'm gonna keep the suit on. No, girl, you bend over, girl. I'm gonna really beat that vagina up. Well, I can't say the P word. I just can't say the P word. That just sounds so disgusting. So I just wanna beat that vagina up. Okay, let me get it in. It's so warm. Wow. Oh, wait. What is that feeling? No, wait. Oh, pull it out. Oh, my God. I got my suit on still. No, babe. It didn't happen all the time. It's just I didn't want to mess up my suit and everything, girl. You're so fine, though, baby. Can you please hold me?
How the fuck you gonna sound, motherfucker? Keep thinking about all that clothes and shit. Bitch. Damn, dog. I'm telling you, Dre, keep dressing that way. Watch. Keep dressing that way and you'll have your little cake ass, little suit on and shit, thinking you doing some shit. So go ahead and dress the way you want to, dog, and watch when you open your bitch ass mouth. Anyway, guys, any questions, man? We're going to wrap. Any more questions, guys, let me know. We'll wrap this up. But, guys, we got y'all covered, dog. And I'm not trying to be mean to him, but we got to wake you motherfuckers up. We got to wake you up, okay? Game is not about sharing your fucking feelings. Game is not about being scared and vulnerable. Game is not lying to fucking women. Tell her what the fuck is going on, man. Come on, man. Man, we got y'all, man. Y'all got to stop that shit, man. Y'all have got to stop being boring. I want you guys to be better men. I know you guys can be better men. But what's important is you got to start believing in yourselves, gentlemen. That's what I'm saying. Believe in yourself. The more you believe in yourself, the more you understand yourself, the more you're going to win. That's it, dog. That's game right there. Okay? Stop doing all this piddly shit, dog. Let her earn your dick. Let her earn your time. Let her earn you. And if she can't earn you, then dismiss her fucking ass and replace her. They do that shit with you motherfuckers all the time. And they sleep like babies. It is time for you guys to let your nuts drop from your stomach. And it is time for you guys to stand on your name and let her make the decision if she wants to fuck with you or not. And whether she wants to fuck with you or not, who gives a fuck? Because she's not the only one that you have, gentlemen. And I promise you, women love when you talk this shit to them, because they ain't used to motherfuckers talking that ism. Gentlemen, please, I say for all you guys out there, and I'm not joking around, I always say this because I do appreciate all you guys. I am trying to get you guys to appreciate yourself. And what I am saying to you guys, in order to appreciate yourself, gentlemen, the first thing you have to do is always remember the graveyard. We're the only ones on YouTube telling you this. Always remember, everybody you see in these motherfucking graveyards, they thought they had tomorrow coming to them. Live every motherfucking day of your life like it is your last. I'm not saying it's going to be your last. I'm saying you got to live like a man, like it is your last, because you got to have a love, admiration, and understanding of yourself. Because if you don't love yourself, nobody's going to love you. If you don't love yourself, nobody's going to love you. And I'm not saying be mean. Guys, we're great lovers. We treat women really well, but they have to earn that shit. They have to earn our time and our attention. They have to earn our respect. And then the benefits of a man is that they get to be loved the way they want to be loved by a man, because men are great lovers, gentlemen. Men are great lovers, but we just don't give the dick away. We talked about it earlier. We turn down women. We guys, I promise you, you will be able to turn pussy down. I promise you. Y'all don't see it right now, but there's going to come a time and you're going to be like, man, damn, oh man, fuck. I don't feel like fucking right now. I don't want to fuck with you right now. Y'all be like, what? I'm telling you, y'all be able to do that, okay? All right? So please understand this, okay? Y'all are great men. Y'all just got to learn how to be great. Fuck with your boy.
What up, yo? It's your boy, Paige Kennedy. You already know what it is. And you're listening to TheManMindset.com. Dating help for men with your host, Steve the Dean Williams.
What's up? This is T.O. And you're listening to TheManMindset.com. Dating help for men with your host, Steve the Dean Williams.
This is the Shark Damon John, and you're listening to TheManMindset.com. Dating help for men with your host, Steve the Dean Williams.
Just like that, man mindset. Just like that, man mindset. Have a good night, the show is over. Take notes and use what the dean has told you. Now with dating, your game is colder. No hesitation when you approach her. Gotta level up, gotta keep on rising. Till you the best, got the touch like Midas. Now you got style, you got all the women flocking. So many options, now you got it popping. Thank you for tuning in, ay, just like that, man mindset. Gotta come back again, ay, just like that, man mindset.